Yep, led out by our Spanish referee, Alberto Mayenko. This is the second leg of the Europa League quarter-final, where Manchester United, if Jose Mourinho had had his way last week, the job would already have been done. He believed that they should have won in Brussels by 3-0. As it is, they were pegged back, and so now they must finish off the job. And he's made 5 changes from the side that beat Chelsea here at the weekend. Romero for De Gea, Shaw comes in for Darmian at left back, Carrick for Fellaini, Mkhitaryan for Herrera, and Ibrahimovic for Young. So the United side is Romero in goal, Valencia, Bailly, Rojo and Shaw, Lingard, Carrick and Pogba, Rashford, Mkhitaryan and Ibrahimovic. Anderlecht have made 4 changes from their first leg. They're boosted by the return of the Polish international striker, Juricic, who scored 28 goals this season. He replaces the Swedish international Thielin. Chipchu comes in for Bruno. Ani for Stanciu, another remaining international. And Spajic comes in at the heart of their defence instead of Nightink. So Ruben is in goal. Apia, Spajic, Mbodji. Obradovic is the left back. The midfield of Chipchu, Tielemans, Dendonka, who got that late equaliser, Akiempong, Ani and Tiernicic. And the thing is, Robbie, is that because of United's away goal, Anderlecht here, they might want to sit back and try and frustrate United early on, but ultimately they've got to score a goal to stand any chance of going through.
Yeah, and that could suit Manchester United, especially with the pace of Lingard, Rashford, Mkhitaryan. So, you know, I fancy Manchester United strongly tonight, and as you said, they could have won that game in Belgium 3-0 quite easily, but it's a very strong United side tonight, and I expect them to win this game.
The other 3 ties, by the way, Besiktas against Lyon, Schalke against Ajax and Genk against Celta Vigo, so they potentially could be Manchester United, well they will be Manchester United's potential opponents should they go through of what has been a long campaign, but could prove to be very successful. Already the League Cup in the can. Jose Mourinho, the first United manager to win a major trophy in his first season in charge. And should the Europa League follow, in a competition that has always eluded Manchester United in their illustrious history and its various guises, and of course it would bring the biggest prize of all and a route into the Champions League for next season, bearing in mind that Manchester United are currently 5th with a game in hand on Manchester City but are 4 points adrift. The boisterous Anderlecht supporters are in the corner away to our right. They have been in terrific voice ever since they were allowed into the ground here at Old Trafford. And Anderlecht in their traditional colours, the all-purple. Manchester United, red shirts, white shorts and white socks. And as we were saying before with Henry Winter, the team that United have gone with tonight is set up to hit Anderlecht on the break, should Anderlecht then decide to go forward in search of this away goal.
Yeah, well, but if you look at the middle of the park as well, with Carrick and Pogba, you know, they can keep the ball extremely well. You know, watch out for Pogba's, you know, long diagonals to try and get Lingard, Rashford, you know, Mkhitaryan getting the ball in number 10 position. Can he play little short passes to Zlatan Ibrahimovic, if I can get the words out of Ian? But I'm looking forward to this game.
We're underway. You're listening to Radio 5 Live. Manchester United are defending the Stretford end away to our left. They're 4 playing from left to right. And Bailly will clip the ball up towards Lingard. And it's interesting, after all the problems they caused Chelsea at the weekend, that Rashford has gone out to the left-hand side. Lingard's on the right, but at the central point of United's attack is Ibrahimovic. Because they did ever so well as a front two. The way that they linked up to Rashford and Lingard. But they're on opposite sides of the pitch, but United already have got a throw on this near side to right. That Valencia is going to take. Lingard trying to show himself. In the end, it's Pogba who flicks the ball on and headed away by Obradovic. Ball played in towards Lingard. Lingard then looking towards Ibrahimovic. On the cover was Mbodji at the heart of that defence. And Mkhitaryan overruns it and out of play for a goal kick. Robbie Savage.
Yeah, good start for Manchester United. You know, we're playing Lingard and Rashford wide. You know, what that enables is Valencia and Shaw, two attacking fullbacks. So when they drive inside, Valencia can get on the overlap, so can Luke Shaw. So this United side has got so many attacking capabilities. Already we've seen Valencia trying to get on the outside. I'm sure we'll see Luke Shaw getting on the outside of Rashford when he drives inside. So looking forward to it.
Juricic tries to flick the ball on. With the flick header there was Annie, the Anderlecht captain, as he is one of four players changed from their coach, René Weiler, from the first leg last week. The Swiss coach bringing in the Algerian international. But they actually, in their squad, their playing list, they have nine players on a yellow card. Two, four, six of them are actually in the starting 11. The yellow cards, by the way, are wiped after tonight's game, going into the semi-finals. Manchester United just have Mkhitaryan and Bailly on yellows. Annie out to Akiapong, coming forward now on this left-hand side, carries the ball to the edge of the area, shot takes a deflection, outstretched leg. Rojo then barks at his defence to tell them to bring the ball away. Akiapong will win it back. Behind him is Obradovic. The ball then is played forward, and Dendonka's going to shoot from long range. His right-footed shot was dipping, moved in the air and just dropped. Well, that was 35 yards out. He scored the late equaliser. Would he initially hit it? Nobody thought that there was a real scare, and then it moved in the air and it dropped quite viciously.
Dendonka with a dipper. He's hit it from 35 yards. As you said, it looked like it was going miles over the bar. It's a great strike, head over the ball. You know, Romero was watching it go over. It dipped at the last minute and landed on top of the net. Great strike.
Or as Dan Walker, I think, christened the phrase, a thronker. That was Dendonka with a thronker. 0-0. Radio 5 Live. This Europa League quarter-final, second leg, 1-1 from the first leg. Bemoaned the wasteful opportunities, Mourinho, from that first leg over the head of Mkhitaryan, and that will peter out for a goal kick to Anderlecht. 0-0.
But that little moment of play from Anderlecht come from Bailly missing a challenge in the middle of the park on the captain Annie. You know, he rolled a couple of challenges, and Bailly, the ball was there to be won. He seemed to half pull out. Annie won the ball, got it wide, and then the ball eventually ended up to the Dendonka with a great strike, Denno.
Certainly was. Ruben, the Spanish goalkeeper, is in no hurry to take this goal kick for Anderlecht. We've been playing for 4 minutes, strikes it right-footed. Pogba unchallenged to head it forward. Ibrahimovic climbs over Mbodji. Then the ball is played away by Anderlecht, but there is Valencia just stepping forward to Michael Carrick, the captain for Manchester United, and always a reassuring presence in the midfield. And here is the England international out towards Valencia on this side, closed down by Akiapong, Carrick and Valencia. And Valencia then will switch play in field. Pogba's got to hurry a little bit there to help it on its way past Chipchu over on that far side, but the purple shirts are now back in possession. And Bodgi's forward ball, caught in possession though, is Chipchu. Nice turn, Mkhitaryan for Manchester United, left hand side of the penalty area, forced away from goal, keeps his balance, loses the ball though, and eventually Anderlecht will clear. And it's up to Annie, the captain, coming forward, runs into Michael Carrick, and then Dendonka. Obradovic, the left back, up towards the halfway line, the Serbian defender, and he makes himself available. And now it's passed out to Akiapong. Tielemans got a touch there as well. They're saying that the teenager could be the next hottest thing to come out for Belgian football. Stepping forward, Obradovic continued his run into Carrick. Last touch off the Serbian, out of play for a throw. Certainly for midfield, doesn't do too bad. 18 goals he's scored this season. Potentially the next star of Belgian football. He's certainly produced a few in recent years. However, Hazard here was very subdued due to Herrera, who's on the bench. Much more of an attacking lineup for Manchester United, but he'll be buoyed by that performance as well as the result against Chelsea. Ibrahimovic looking towards Rashford in the penalty area, hooks it right-footed, coming off his goal line was Ruben, the goalkeeper. 0-0, Robbie Savage.
Yeah, Ibrahimovic there got in between Mbodji and Spajic on this right-hand side. Showed his bit of pace there to get away from Spajic. You know, then the ball across the box, but gathered comfortably from Ruben, the goalkeeper. But you know, Anderlecht, decent start, you know, especially that shot from Ndonka, controlling possession. You know, Annie, the skipper in the middle of the park, wants to dictate play. Good start from the Belgium side.
Anderlecht, who have never won in 15 previous trips to England. The ball looking to be thread through to Akir Pong, cleared away by Romero. It's just a softly weighted ball by Annie, helping it on its way, a guiding presence as he goes in for a challenge with Valencia, who says he got the ball, tied it up by Bailly, who goes back to Romero in goal in front of the Stretford end, away to our left-hand side, 0-0 in the opening 6.5 minutes here at Old Trafford. Pogba to Luke Shaw, playing at left back, back with Pogba, and now with Bailly, brings the ball under control. In between the two central defenders is Carrick, on a very mild evening here in Manchester, a clear night too. Bailly, Jose Mourinho already at his technical area. Always think that's a gauge as well when you see a manager so early on there watching on. As Lingard caught in possession. I think Anderlecht will be quietly encouraged by the start they've made.
Yeah, they've got Ndonka just sitting in front of the back four as well, so any high ball up to Zlatan Ibrahimovic, he can just try and win the first ball, get in front of him, so he's doing that job quite well at the minute.
Pogba receives the ball from Shaw, switches play out to this near side. Valencia is forced back inside his own half, over the halfway line, playing from left to right, Manchester United. Lingard is being tracked there by Ndonka. The noise being generated by that boisterous bunch away to our right. And Mbodji steps out of defence, forward to Annie, takes it in his stride, gets away from the sliding attentions of Pogba. Teodosic can't control the ball as it came over his right shoulder, dropped into the penalty area, and Romero picks it up.
Well, it was a brilliant play from Annie on the right-hand side. He whipped the ball into the space for Teodosic to run to. He got in between Rojo and Bailly, and if he could control that, Ian, there could have been 1-0.
Tielemans will come forward. Chipchu on the far side, the right, doesn't deliver the cross, stopped by Shaw, plays the ball along the ground, but Rashford was expecting it to go long. It was easily intercepted. Cross comes in from the right hand side, Valencia will control the ball, tucked in the right back, but they pressed on him, and Lingard's come back to help out, but still deep inside their own half. In fact, he's in his penalty area, there is Valencia, and a clearance to Mkhitaryan midway through his own half for Manchester United. And Mkhitaryan away from Ndonka, but Ndonka quickly recovers, gets goal side, wins the ball back for Anderlecht. Tielemans, Ndonka behind Teodosic, and now Pogba will turn away from Tielemans, look towards Ibrahimovic. Rashford will get there though. Rashford's first ball cut out by Mbodji, comes back to Rashford. Mkhitaryan's unmarked. Here is Mkhitaryan! Manchester United take an early lead. Inside 10 minutes, Mkhitaryan low right footed. Manchester United 1, Anderlecht 0.
Well, first and foremost, what a fantastic ball from Pogba. Everybody thought he was going to try and play Zlatan Ibrahimovic in. He didn't. He went for Rashford on that left-hand side. He used his pace, Rashford, and then he picked out Mkhitaryan. Mkhitaryan, one touch, right-footed, shot low, past the goalkeeper, Rubin. Spajic couldn't close him down. Fantastic counter-attack. Pogba in the middle of the park, it was. The pass, Rashford's pace on that left-hand side was brilliant. You know, he tried to find Ibrahimovic, he couldn't, it was cut out, poor clearance from Mbodji, and then Mkhitaryan, unmarked, rifles it in the bottom corner, 1-0 United.
Would you have to question why nobody from Anderlecht tracked back with Mkhitaryan, because he had so much space?
He certainly did, and, you know, that's, he won the ball as well in the left-back position, you know, and he continued his run, great desire from Mkhitaryan, it's a pity an Anderlecht player couldn't match him.
Well, Mkhitaryan at this stage last year had the... certainly an opportunity, as they'll come forward here, Will Anderlecht, with Borussia Dortmund in what was a thrilling game at Anfield. However, Rashford's just been pulled back. However, Manchester United now with that goal really looking to... Tielemans has just been booked, and he is one of the players who's on a yellow card, so he would not play should Anderlecht turn it around.
Oh, Rashford there once again, his pace, he stood Tielemans up and then just knocked it past him. Wow, what pace and power from Rashford. Tielemans rugby tackled him to the ground, yellow card.
So contrasting fortunes for Mkhitaryan, and maybe in this competition going through to the semi-finals, because now Anderlecht, well, we knew that they had to score, so in that sense it doesn't change anything, but a second goal for Manchester United certainly would. But Manchester United would have wanted the early goal just to ease any nerves, and Mkhitaryan has provided it. 1-0 they lead, and it is the Armenian who's going to take the corner kick on this right-hand side. Anderlecht have everybody back. Mkhitaryan now with the outswing of Pogba with a header! Tipped over by the goalkeeper, Ruben.
Good delivery from Mkhitaryan, this right-hand side. He whips it to buy the penalty spot. It was behind Pogba. He's leapt back and used those neck muscles. He's powered it to the top corner. But you've got to say, Ruben diving away to his right, tips it over the bar. Fingertip save. Great header, great save.
Corner kick that Rashford's going to take on that left-hand side for Manchester United, already leading by a goal to nil. It's a wicked ball in, headed out by a tumbling Spites. Comes back to Rashford on the left-hand side. Lovely ball into Lingard. Goes for a curling effort, and the goalkeeper again produces another wonderful save. Tumbling away, diving to his left to turn it behind for a corner.
Electric start for Manchester United, 1-0 up. Rashford and Lingard enjoying themselves. It was on the left-hand side. Rashford, great bit of skill, chipped it in between the two players. And then Lingard opened his body, whipped it to the far corner. Great save once again, Ruben.
Mkhitaryan with a corner, headed out at the near post by Annie. Retrieved by Rashford, runs over on that far side. Ibrahimovic takes it over, plays it in towards Rojo. The goalkeeper went to scoop it up at the near side, at the near post, and didn't do so at the first attempt, and then throws the ball out. But two excellent saves as they're closed down at the back, and it'll be picked up once again by Ruben. Mourinho complained that United didn't win the first leg 3-0. They could easily have been 3-0 up already inside 13 minutes.
Well, they've carried on from where they left off at the weekend, you know, against Chelsea. Such intensity, pressing high, good pace, power, especially in the wide areas. You know, Pogba with that pass for the goal was brilliant. Real good start for Manchester United.
Djuricic with the layoff. Akiem Pong has popped up on the right at the moment, but he's caught offside, and that will be a free kick to Manchester United. So Jose Mourinho will be extremely content, and for the time being, it silenced that noisy travelling support from Belgium. Although they have scored in every one of their 7 away games in Europe. However, for Manchester United this season, they're unbeaten in all 35 games when scoring first during this campaign. And they lead already 1-0, and it could have been more. Been an excellent start after Mkhitaryan's goal.
Yeah, it was going to be a difficult task for Anderlecht tonight, Ian, wasn't it? I think United unbeaten the last 16 European games at Old Trafford, winning 13, drawing 3. The last time they lost was against Real Madrid here, wasn't it? 2012-13, yes. So always going to be a difficult task, and the way United have started, I think they realise that now.
That's Robbie Savage, who's clearly been doing his homework ahead of this second leg for you on 5 Live.
I'll give Pogba. You a few more after, if you
don't worry, I've got them all. Mkhitaryan out to Pogba, and Bodgil headed away from Pogba on that Manchester United left. And he invites the challenge from the French international, and indeed it will be an Anderlecht throw. Yeah, Real Madrid won 2-1 that night in 2013. But you're right, 16 games over the last 4 seasons. But more importantly,
that's a long time to wear that out.
More importantly for Manchester United, it still keeps. Well, there's a break on maybe for Anderlecht. It's coming forward with Annie. Stopped by Rojo, picks himself off the floor. Annie then switches play out to the left, looking towards Akiem Pong, and Romero will gather. It gives them still dual options for replacing the Champions League for next season. They've got the Manchester Derby coming up. They're 4 points behind their neighbour City, albeit with a game in hand. But of course, should they win this competition, then a place in Europe's elite would beckon too. Despite Mourinho being quite dismissive of the Europa League at the start of the season, it now has taken on much greater significance for Manchester United. Pogba, and they lead 1-0 in this quarter-final second leg. 2-1 on aggregate. Ibrahimovic draws out Spajic, the defender. Plays the ball out towards the right, Valencia. Returns the ball to Ibrahimovic plays it back. Mkhitaryan looks up. Blocked though, came in from Dundonka. Picked up by Pogba. 30 yards out from goal. Shaw goes on the overlap. Pogba though still has the ball. And it will be Tielemans who makes the challenge. Kept in play on that far side. And I would imagine too, from a UEFA point of view, the final of course is in Stockholm, the 24th of May. For Ibrahimovic, that would be the marketing man's dream, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
For him to be in the final.
And Manchester United, another European final. Yeah, I remember when they won the Cup Winners' Cup, you know, against Barcelona. Mark Hughes with, you know, that wonderful goal from that right-hand side. You know, any European final for Manchester United, that's what this club needs to be in, European finals. And, you know, if they can get to this final, which I think they will, and Zlatan Ibrahimovic back in Stockholm, you know, it'll be remarkable. But look at this United side, and I would say probably, with the exception of De Gea for Romero and possibly Herrera for Carrick, you know, it's probably the strongest team. You know, so if they can add one or two in the summer of real quality, maybe three or four, you know, they could, for me, I would make them favourites already for the league next season.
That's the voice of Robbie Savage on Radio 5 Live as Rojo's over the halfway line. Short diagonal ball, gets it back from Lingard, already leading 1-0. We've been playing for 17 and a half minutes. Rojo overran the ball on that far side. He's actually stayed down and he's writhing in agony at the moment, and Ibrahimovic I think has spotted that and will roll the ball out of play to allow the physios to come on to Marcus Rojo, who certainly with the games that could still continue to come thick and fast, and this is the sixth game of nine in a 30-day spell for the month of April.
Yes, Rojo's on the left-hand side. He just overruns the ball, as you rightly said, and he stretches for it. He seems to kick the ball, then chipped you, and then seemed to fall back on his knee a little bit. Did his knee go underneath him? Just watching now replay on our screens. He won the ball. His knee seemed to collide with Chipchew, and then he seemed to fall back when his knee, for a moment, just seemed to fall underneath him. So, doesn't look good that for Rojo.
And of course, it's an area where they're already missing Jones. They're already missing Smalling as well. And as I say, you know, if they were to get through to the semi-finals, you know, potentially there could be a further 10 more games this season for Manchester United.
You know, the way he fell there was, remember when Mane fell against Everton in the derby, when that kind of motion, when he fell, when his knee seemed to get stuck in the turf a little bit and his body weight seemed to go backwards. You know, hopefully he'll be okay, Rojo, but didn't look good that.
Well, Blint is warming up in front of us just as a precaution. Rojo is now on his feet. Manchester United leading already by a goal to nil. And the physio actually just put his hands up on that far side. So that would imagine to be the all clear as far as Marcus Rojo is concerned, which will be of a massive relief to Jose Mourinho, Robbie.
Yeah, it's important now just to watch Rojo for the next couple of minutes, because what happens, you know, those type of injuries, you can come back on and as soon as you start running, you know, it might start hurting again. But it looks like he's come back on now, Rojo. Seems to be moving okay. That's a huge positive that he's going to be okay for Manchester United.
Baeta Valencia. Just continue to monitor his progress over the next couple of minutes or so. Here is Pogba. Valencia, Baye, Carrick now in the centre circle. Switched out to Shaw on the left-hand side. Red shirts, white shorts, playing from left to right. Carrick's on the halfway line. Closed down by Tielemans, back with Baye. It's interesting why they've kept the ball. They've deliberately bypassed Rojo, who was almost a few yards further back than everybody else. It was like he didn't want to be involved until he was feeling his way back into the game.
Yeah, the Mourinho just come into the technical area and he was screaming at Baye. He said, play the ball, pass the ball around you. But obviously, you know, the player just monitored Rojo and think, is he okay? And he's limping.
Well, he's limping.
Struggling.
And that came because, oh, Akiapong could be in. Akiapong puts it wide. Romero off his goal line. Rojo cannot continue. He was certainly exposed there. And Akiapong almost took advantage, but as Romero came off his line, left-footed it, he put it the wrong side of the post into the side netting, but Rojo has gone down again.
Yeah, it didn't look comfortable. He was chasing the ball, he was limping onto it, you know, and Akiapong won the ball, passed by, You know, the keeper comes at Romero. Akiyepo opens his body up. He's bearing down on goal. Side foots it. But he put it past the post. Great opportunity. But that's not good for Rojo. He'd be coming off. That is a worry. As I said, Dwayne, you know, when the initial injury happened, you come back on for 3 or 4 minutes, see what it's like, but obviously it's no good. You know, that could be a season-ending injury. Hopefully not for Marcus Rojo, because he's been brilliant for Manchester United.
Well, Marcus Rashford's actually come across just to check on Rojo, and actually has a consoling pat there to the body of the Manchester United defender, who's going to be replaced by Daley Blint. But the thing is that the stretcher has now been called for, so this is going to be a lengthy interruption. In fact, they've actually done quite well to put him onto the stretcher, and he's now being carried off. So the Argentinian makes way for Daley Blint, and Manchester United's defensive injury worries mount. As you've mentioned, Smalling and Jones has a toe injury. Smalling has a leg injury that was picked up with the England internationals. Corner kick going to be taken, and it's headed away by Valencia at the near post. So Daley Blint has come on, and already that change being made midway through the first half. Robbie Savage.
Yeah, and Rojo, it was his right knee, and then when he went to make the tackle on Akiyepon, he kicked out. You know, then his knee seemed to go again, so that is not good for Marcus Rojo, Manchester United.
Pogba out to Shaw. Lingard's made the run ahead of him, left hand side of the penalty area, and Budgie's gone with him out to Shaw, just in from the touchline. Plays the ball back. Pogba forced away from goal, now with Bailly in the centre circle of the Manchester United half. Red shirts, white shorts, playing from left to right as we look. Valencia has no options, actually says that with the hands out open wide, as you say, well, who can I pass the ball to? So he has to go back to Blint. And now with Pogba, Valencia's now made a run forward, as has Ibrahimovic. It might get there, no. Watchful defending by Mbodji. And the referee's blown his whistle anyway, as Lingard will fire the volley in at the goalkeeper. 1-0 to Manchester United.
Yeah, Pogba just inside the centre circle in his own half. You know, hit a straight ball to Ibrahimovic. And the ball nearly got there, but he just nudged Mbodji in the back. Correct decision from the referee, but it was Lingard, interestingly, he was following up for the second ball. He was the one on the front foot. Again, no tracking back from those Anderlecht players, which led, obviously, that first goal. Nobody tracked Mkhitaryan. He fired it in the bottom corner.
And that's the goal that separates the two sides on the night. A goal after 10 minutes for Manchester United. The lead on aggregate is 2-1. Anderlecht, though, have had a couple of opportunities. We mentioned that one for Akiyepong after 21 minutes, but the earlier one from long range was Dendonka after 3. Spajic, the central defender, the 23-year-old Serbian international. Ruben, the goalkeeper, clears. The ball spins through the air. Djuricic brings it under control. Ani is ahead of him. Spins 360 degrees. Tielemans will switch play out to that far side. Appiah has joined the attack, the right back. It's Appiah's cross. Djuricic heads it back into the penalty area. I think he was surprised it actually reached him. Manchester United clear only as far as Dendonka. And the ball now is with the left back, Obradovic. Akiyepong will give it back to Obradovic. Lingard goes with him. The diminutive figure of Akiyepong is bundled over by Valencia. Free kick, but Annie's taking it too far forward. And it'll have to come back for Anderlecht, who trail by a goal to nil.
Yeah, he was surprised. Djuricic there in the box. It was a free header. Trying to place it down to an Anderlecht play. Maybe he should have tried to brought it down on his chest. Oh.
Coming forward now. Appiah into the penalty area. And Romero with the save. It was the shot from Dendonka, right-footed. Didn't seem to strike it too cleanly. Appiah had made the surging run into the penalty area, hit it first time.
The keeper didn't save it. Dendonka, as you say, he kicked it from his right foot onto his left. Romero didn't touch it.
In comes the corner kick, headed away by Ibrahimovic. It looked like Romero had just touched the ball away.
No, he didn't. No, he missed it. You can see by the goalkeeper's reaction. You know, Dendonka with a clear shot, 18 yards out. He kicked it from his right foot onto his left. That made it look like he took a deflection.
Goal kick now to Anderlecht. Akiyapon couldn't control the ball.
But another chance for Anderlecht. That's three decent chances in this game. United with only one real clear-cut chance, which Mkhitaryan put away. But Anderlecht, you know, believe they can get an equaliser here, and they've had three good chances.
Well, the thing is, they're going to have to score. That's the thing now. I mean, they always had to score anyway. Certainly, Dendonka has had two of the three opportunities that Robbie's talking about. 27 minutes played. Manchester United lead by a goal to nil. Akiyapong. Now with Dendonka. Short, dark hair, quite tall midfielder. Looks cumbersome at times, but he's certainly not afraid to have a shot. Look, free kick and a direct free kick. And he's been fouled.
Yeah, the captain, Annie, getting to good positions there. He drives in from the left-hand side, gets about 25 yards out, centre of goal. Pogba was wrong side, brought him down. Good opportunity this for Anderlecht.
It's fractionally left of centre. It's a good 25 yards out from goal. Maybe even a shade further than that. And Youri Tielemans is the player who's going to take it. Now, Manchester United have brought everybody back. We've got five in the wall. There's a couple, and in fact, Oni's just walking away from that as well. Fjordicic has placed himself right on the end of that wall as well. So, Youri Tielemans, who they say is the next rising star of Belgian football, has an opportunity to make his mark here at Old Trafford. But right-footed, his free kick curls over the wall, doesn't have the power, and safely in the arms of Romero.
Yeah, it was a very big wall for Manchester United there. Carrick, Ibrahimovic, Pogba. You know, it's going to have to be a tremendous free kick there, but you rightly said, Ian, not enough power on it. Romero gathered it comfortably. No danger on his goal on that occasion.
Besiktas are leading Lyon by a goal to nil in Istanbul. So that has levelled it up on the on aggregate. Besiktas have the away goal because Lyon won the first leg 2-1. So Besiktas 1, Lyon 0. Schalke against Ajax, I assume, is still 0-0. Ajax were leading 2-0 from the first leg in Amsterdam. And Genk 2, Celta Vigo 3 from the first leg. So that return leg is being played in Belgium. And that's still 0-0 as well. Manchester United lead here by a goal to nil.
They've just lost a bit of momentum, Manchester United, haven't they? You know, since Rojo went off. You know, Anderlecht are keeping the ball. Annie in the middle of the park's dictating play. Tielemans is having an influence as well. We haven't hardly seen Carrick, mention Carrick's name, or the guy with 28 goals, Ibrahimovic. You know, he looks a bit isolated. He's not holding the ball up. To be fair, the service to him has been poor. You know, they've not got Rashford in the game or Lingard since the goal. So it just looks like for a moment or two that the Marcus Rojo injury has affected them.
There was that flurry of activity after the goal where Manchester United could easily have scored another two. As Shaw puts it across, it's just behind Lingard. His outstretched left foot couldn't direct the ball goalwards. But as Robbie says, Manchester United have since lost a little bit of momentum. And Anderlecht still in the tie, very much so.
That was good play from Luke Shaw down that left-hand side. Rashford drove inside. Luke Shaw got to the byline and cut it back, but there was only Lingard in the box.
Here's Rashford, midway through the Anderlecht half. Forward ball, Ibrahimovic turns to Mkhitaryan. Right corner of the penalty area now. Lingard's cross is blocked. Akiyapong will bring it away. Holds off at Lingard. Fjordicic will come back to help out, trying to link up. Turns midway through his own half. And the Polish international striker leaves it for the Serbian Spajic, who then gets the ball back and has got a little bit more time now to assess his options. And it's a right-footed ball that is chipped long. Headed away, though, by Bailly on the halfway line. Anderlecht, though, are now in possession. Tielemans in field. Dendonka, just outside the centre circle, spreads a long ball, searching, and picks out Chipchu. Good control. Crosses into the penalty area. And this might actually fall to Tielemans, who shoots, takes a deflection onto the bar. Fjordicic is there, can't get the loose ball, but then they do. And it's Annie who's rammed in that loose ball. And Anderlecht have got the away goal that they craved. And it's 1-1.
Yeah, we said United are having a poor spell ever since Rojo went off. The ball went onto the right-hand side, as you said, Ian. What a ball from Dendonka. He sprayed it 60 yards to that far side. Chipchu puts the ball in. Eventually fell to Tielemans on the edge of the box. And it was a deflected shot. It beat Romero. It hit the underside of the crossbar. Tiedjuk was first to react. He couldn't get the ball under the control. and then it fell to Annie, the skipper, who smashes it into the goal past Blin, past Romero, 1-1.
An element of good fortune, how it reached Annie. But Anderlecht's captain didn't disappoint, because Teodosic at times was like a startled rabbit, because it looked easier for him to score off the rebound, off the bar. But Annie certainly didn't deliberate to drill it in.
Well, we said, didn't we? You know, Anderlecht on a good spell. United, since the goal, have been...
Manchester United's attack is cut out by Mbadji. Well, they've had opportunities. They've stayed in the tie, and now they're coming forward again. And Manchester United, who we were saying had lost their way, lost that little bit of momentum, as Pogba will give away a free kick. And Anderlecht now are certainly buoyant.
Yeah, Obradovic there getting forward as well. Akia Pom made the run forward, that left-hand side. You know, and Pogba getting back. Commit the foul on Obradovic.
There's Tielemans, goes back. Anderlecht supporters have certainly enjoyed that goal. Remember, they've never won in England. Showing my age, I remember the 84 UEFA Cup final, the Tony Park save against Tottenham, when, of course, the final was a two-legged affair. And Martin Olsen, of course, was a mainstay of that that Anderlecht side. They're not necessarily able to have such illustrious players now playing for them. Instead, they have to bring the rising players through, those with potential, before selling them on. But certainly they haven't lacked ambition or adventure here.
Yeah, you've got to say it. You know, United scored, they had a good chance from Pogba, you know, good header, good save. You know, Lingard with a curling shot, decent save again from Ruben. But other than that, Anderlecht have looked very threatening. Akia Pom should have scored when he was one-on-one with Romero. They've been very good in possession, Anderlecht, as well. We just need Pogba, Carrick to get all the ball, try and use the pace of Rashford and Lingard. You know, the balls to Ibrahimovic have been poor. Well, he's had no service whatsoever.
We've seen some familiar faces in terms of Premier League scouts as well in the director's box just to our left. So there will be a few who are making some notes about this Anderlecht side, because they're coming forward. But at the moment, Anderlecht have the edge, as Annie will pass the ball to Appiah. Chipchu, who delivered that excellent cross, and the Romanian tries to wriggle free, and Chipchu's into the penalty area, and he pulls the ball back. Tielemans looking towards Dendonka, taken away by Blint. It was a vital intervention by Blint. Mkhitaryan now will come surging forward to Manchester United. He runs into Annie.
He's Annie. Playing well, the captain. He's got the goal. He's dictating play in the middle of the park.
Annie, 26 years of age, a Frenchman who plays his football for Algeria. He's only got the three caps as an Algerian international now, switching his allegiance as Rashford opens his legs and accelerates and beaten out of the near post. Tell you what, Robbie, we've got a terrific cup tie in our hands now. Corner kick, 1-1.
Brilliant. Just get the ball to Rashford. Every time he gets the ball, he knocks it past Appiah. He's got the beating of him that time on the left-hand side. Drives into the box, tries to smash it across goal's left foot. Good save of the near post from Ruben.
So Manchester United, 1-1 against Anderlecht in this first half. Radio 5 live. Rashford to take it, in swinging corner. Headed up in the air by Tielemans. Ibrahimovic will get there. Anderlecht will clear. Annie, who's just brought them level, skies the ball. And out of play it goes for a throw in front of that Sir Alex Ferguson stand over on the far side. And Manchester United's former manager is here watching on. And this competition, this only UEFA title to elude Manchester United. And Mourinho patrols and prowls that technical area down below.
You know, it's games like this, quarter-final of a European competition, you want to see Pogba dictate the play, get on the ball, demand it, get United going. His pass for, which led up to the goal, was brilliant. He's on the ball now.
Pogba shoots from distance and actually kicks the ground and annoys it himself, because it was a rising right-footed drive that went well, well high and wide. And it's still 1-1, 2-2 on aggregate.
Yeah, looks a bit frustrated, Pogba. You know, he keeps getting wrong side of Annie. You know, Annie's doing exceptionally well for Anderlecht, but these are the games you want to see Paul Pogba dictate, be instrumental, demand more of himself and his other players.
The Anderlecht supporters are making the noise. They're bouncing up and down in unison away to our right-hand side. And here are the purple shirts with Annie. Some excellent footwork and control there by the Anderlecht captain. He's certainly reveling in his role tonight, that is for sure. And he's just won a throw.
Yeah, that shouldn't happen. And he controlled the ball on the halfway line. He juggled it 3, 4, 5 times, then passed the ball off. You know, somebody's got to be smashing into him there, try and win the ball. You know, you can't let an opposition player or Trafford juggle the ball four or five times before contact.
The Belgian Footballer of the Year last year was the Algerian international when he scored 17 goals. He's just taken his tally to 12 for this campaign and given Anderlecht real hope that they might be able to cause an upset against Manchester United. However, Manchester United have been awarded a free kick.
Yes,
Ibrahimovic fouled.
Good refereeing here and that. Ibrahimovic went for the header. Spajic was pulling to the ground. The referee see if United got an advantage. They didn't. He's brought it back.
Quick free kick. Offside against Lingard. He's pulled it wide anyway.
Good thinking though from Mkhitaryan. He's alert. He's alive. Lingard with a clever little run. Just went a bit too early. I'd like to see that on a replay, and I'm not sure. He could have been onside there. The linesman put his flag up very quickly. We're just going to see the replay on our TVs. Just fractions offside. Good decision from the linesman.
A second away goal for Anderlecht, and then that would certainly make life very interesting for Manchester United. Mourinho is taken back to his seat rather than standing and watching on in that technical area. Akiapong looking towards Tjuricic, but it was Bailly who intercepted. Ibrahimovic with the flick to Rashford. Rashford at the moment has been United's best player, coming forward again on that left-hand side. Pogba. Shaw. Pogba just outside the D, trying to get room to shoot. Good block came in, I think it was from Spajic. Surely climbing over Tjuricic was Bailly. No foul, says the Spanish referee. Carrick out to Shaw. Shaw's forward ball, holding the width on that left touchline, then waits and plays it into Pogba, chips it forward. Shaw's continued his run. Shaw shoots! Never scored a goal in his senior career. Straight at the goalkeeper, Ruben, 1-1.
Brilliant though from Manchester United down that left-hand side. Pogba with a great ball, reverse pass, and he was looking towards Zlatan Ibrahimovic instead of forward position. He reversed it to Luke Shaw with a great run. The ball landed in the penalty area. First time control on his left foot onto his right. Not enough power in the shot. At the near post, Ruben gathered it low down. But good play for Manchester United.
Anderlecht, who've conceded 18 goals in their three previous visits to Old Trafford, including a 10-0 defeat in the European Cup back in 1956, could well have happier memories to return to Belgium. Holding Manchester United 1-1. As Manchester United will have a throw and they want to take it quickly. Mkhitaryan to Lingard. The Armenian gets it back. Strokes it back towards Carrick. As Pogba goes back to Blint. And Blint outside the centre circle of his own half. Along the ground. Lyon have got an equaliser in Istanbul. Lacazette has scored. Akiapong couldn't take advantage of a counter-attack for Anderlecht. So Besiktas 1, Lyon 1. It means that Lyon are back in front overall. 3-2 in aggregate. Still no goals against Schalke and Ajax. And Genk against Celta Vigo.
Tendonka and Annie for Anderlecht are doing so well because they're playing the ball in between the lines. Chipchu, Akiapong, they're getting in behind Carrick and Pogba. Coming inside, you know, then if they gather the ball, they'll be straight at United's back four. So Annie and Tendonka for Anderlecht, they're dictating play. You're going to see Carrick and Pogba doing that for Manchester United.
It's funny as well that Anderlecht were actually eliminated by Rostov in the Champions League playoff as Ibrahimovic gives the ball away, a side that Manchester United have already accounted for in this competition. And in the group stages, they couldn't beat Saint Etienne, who Manchester United eliminated as well. Yet Manchester United at the moment being held here by Anderlecht. Valencia, right-hand side, 1-1. Cross comes in, bounces just outside the penalty area. Chipchu will chest it back, and Tielemans will now bring it away. Tjuricic makes the run out towards the right-hand side. They've committed men forward. Chipchu and Tielemans as well had both made burst through. It's an Anderlecht throw that Tielemans will help on its way back out to Tjuricic. keeps it in play, brings it under control with his right foot, around knee height, edge of the penalty area he goes, right down by the byline. Challenge was made by Blint, the substitute, kept in play by Rashford, and Rashford opens up his arms. Who can I pass the ball to?
Yeah, Ibrahimovic was standing behind Spied and Mbodji. He's got to come and show for the ball there. That was the option.
Lingard drifts in field, now picks out Pogba. Pogba running forward, Mkhitaryan's ahead of him. Great footwork by Mkhitaryan. How he brought that ball down right-footed, around waist height, onto his left foot, but the shot was wide. Goal kick, 1-1.
Yeah, Mkhitaryan's the one trying to get forward. And there was Pogba running down the middle of the field. As you say, Ian, great control from Mkhitaryan, because it wasn't the best pass from Pogba. Gathered it, shoulder height on his right foot. One bounce, left foot volley, high and wide. But what a good first half we've had here, Ian, at Old Trafford.
Certainly have, as Juan Mata, who's in the director's box, and he's just been sitting a matter of seats away from Robbie and myself here, has decided to head for a little bit of half-time refreshment. So with 2 minutes to go to half-time, of course, he's out with a groin problem at the moment, is Juan Mata, as Michael Carrick demands the ball off Valencia with his years of experience, the captain for the home side. Quite vocal as well, communicating to Pogba. I think he's also wanting somebody to drop in. There was a bit of a gap there between himself and Pogba with Michael Carrick to drop into that hole, as Mkhitaryan now, his first time cross was blocked by Obradovic, picked up by Carrick, coming forward, continues to run on this right hand side. Lingard couldn't roll away from Spajic, who can't control the ball, and they've given it away of Anderlecht. Here is Rashford, Carrick, short and square, Mkhitaryan with his back to goal, to Pogba. Shaw joins the attack, floats the ball into the penalty area, over the head of Lingard, out of play for a goal kick. And we've got 60 seconds remaining of this first half, 1-1, Robbie Savage.
Yeah, but there you want to see more movement from Ibrahimovic. You know, he's standing level with, or parallel to Luke Shaw, you know, 20 yards away. You want to see him just spin off and get to that back post. He stands still, no movement. You know, it was Lingard trying to get on the end of a header. They just want to see more movement from Zlatan Ibrahimovic. You know, hardly any movement this first half from the big Swede up front. Just want to see him offer a bit more to this side in the second half.
We'll find out how much added on time there will be from the fourth official here at Old Trafford, Radio 5 Live. 1-1, 2-2 on aggregate. Blint to Pogba, brings the ball under control on the edge of the centre circle in his own half, and out to Rashford over on that far side, and 2 minutes of added on time, which we're now into. But Apia has won it back for Anderlecht. Chipchu out to the right back, keeps the ball in play.
The referee has indicated a minimum of...
There's confirmation of the 2 minutes as Tjuricic is away for Anderlecht, looking towards Akiapong. Akiapong with his back to goal, pulls it back, Tielemans, it might reach Annie, goes around the goalkeeper, and actually then it was too tight, ran out of space, and it went away off his right foot and out of play for a goal kick. But again, the alarm bells were ringing.
Well, Tielemans made the run, you know, as Tjuricic on that right-hand side. Blind tried to dive in, nick the ball. He used his strength, Tjuricic. There was a key upon the box, laid it back to Tielemans, who's put it across. Bailly was slow, got a nick on it, and it fell to Annie. And if his touch was better, Ian, he was round Romero, and he would have struck the ball into the empty net. Another chance for Anderlecht, and he's got his head on his hands, on his head, hands on his head, not his head on his hands. Good moment, that.
We've said before that Anderlecht have scored at least one in all seven away games in Europe this season. You wouldn't at the moment, certainly on the first half display, discount them scoring again, because they have created chances here at Old Trafford. They're coming forward. Obradovic, the left back. Tjuricic was a little bit too stationary and easily dispossessed by Pogba, and the referee will give the free kick in favour of Manchester United for Tjuricic's challenge on Pogba. And that was Obradovic, who was coming back there and needlessly kicked the ball away. He isn't on a yellow card, but it was referees just told him to cut it out, and just a warning. But the 2 minutes of added on time are all but over, and it's 1-1. And if Jose Mourinho thought that this tie should have been all done and dusted after the first leg, will be saying exactly the same, because after they scored after 10 minutes, the goalkeeper Ruben made two excellent saves. They could have been 3-0 up inside a quarter of an hour. However, as the half-time whistle sounds, they still have work to do if they're to reach the last four, because Anderlecht have come back. They've levelled the tie at 1-1. Robbie Savage.
Yeah, it's a positive start for United. Great start for United with that goal from Mkhitaryan. Good finish, right-footed past Ruben, who then, as you said, pulled off two terrific saves. One from Pogba's header, one from Lingard. But then Rojo went off and Anderlecht took control of the game. Annie in the middle of the park, he got the equaliser. You know, they've had a couple of chances. Great atmosphere. 1-1. What a good game we've got, Ian.
Second half to come at Old Trafford. This Europa League quarter-final second leg. Manchester United 1, Anderlecht 1. Well, Ellie, Manchester United's only previous quarter-final in this competition was 84-85, and they lost to Videoton. Big Ron was the manager then, and they lost on penalties. And as it stands at the moment, this is the only scoreline where after extra time we could have a potential penalty shootout. Of course, Jose Mourinho will hope that it doesn't come to that. He hasn't made any alterations at half-time. He did, of course, make a substitution during that first half. Rojo going off injured and Blint coming on for him. So the United side is Romero in goal, a back four of Valencia, Bailly and Blint, Shaw as left-back, Carrick and Pogba, Lingard, Mkhitaryan the goal scorer, Rashford and Ibrahimovic. Anderlecht in their all purple haven't made any changes either, as our Spanish referee is about to get us underway, as Manchester United in this second half will be attacking the Stretford end, so they'll be playing from right to left as we look. And Ruben is in goal for Anderlecht. Appiah, Spajic and Bodgi, and Obradovic is the defence for Anderlecht. Tielemans and Dendonka in the centre of midfield. Chipchu, Annie, Akiapong are behind the lone striker, Teodorchuk. So Manchester United with Valencia quickly on the ball on that right-hand side. And now to Lingard. And now with Blint. And Anderlecht, I'm sure, their coach, Rennie Weiler, will just be saying, same again, Robin.
Same again, and they wouldn't have wanted half-time to come. They were, you know, counter-attacking well. They were in control of the game. You know, they... the only shot on target they score from, but it was a very good first half. You know, the stats would suggest or say that United had more of the ball, 65% possession for United, which surprised me. And I thought Anderlecht would control that, but you know, just get the ball to Rashford. He's had the beating of Appiah, the left back. Every time he gets the ball, he goes past him. Get it to him as often as you can and get bodies in the box.
Although that, what Robbie says is correct, that they did score from their only shot on target. They have had other opportunities. Dendonka going from long range. Akiapong hit the side netting. Shaw is forward on this left-hand side, and he stretches to try and bring that ball under control. And in fact, he will win a corner kick, because Appiah was taking no chances on this near side. So straight away, Rashford will place the ball down in front of the Stretford end. Manchester United have a corner kick. Rashford with the delivery on the left-hand side. Flick on from Ibrahimovic has been cleared away on that far side, the Anderlecht left. Back towards Rashford. Rolls up his chest and he runs into trouble as Anderlecht will clear. And Tielemans pings the ball forward. Teodorchuk, he gets away as he rolls clear of Valencia. He's into the penalty area. He steadies himself and Valencia then gets himself back, gets the block in, and the ball's diverted behind for a corner kick.
Oh, danger signs. They are a threat on the break, aren't they? Only Genk and Roma have scored more goals than Anderlecht in the Europa League this season. They've got 24, Anderlecht got 23. That could have been another one, and it should have been.
And what a ball sprayed forward by Tielemans, who now just walks over towards that far side for this corner kick. 1-1 on the night, 2-2 on aggregate. Corner kick curling in, punched away by Romero inside his 6-yard area. One of five changes that Jose Mourinho made from the side that beat Chelsea here in the Premier League at the weekend. And coming up, of course, on 5 Live Sport on Saturday, we'll start in Scotland, we'll then go to Wales and we'll finish in England. Hibs against Aberdeen in the Scottish Cup semi-final, Swansea against Stoke City, and the usual goal service as far as the league action is concerned. And then it's back to cup action, Chelsea against Tottenham in the first of the FA Cup semi-finals to be played over the weekend.
Then 6-6.
and then 6:06. I haven't forgot. Who could ever forget 6:06 with you, Robin? And of course, that new number of 08085909 and 693. I always do the "and" just for you.
You're going back to that pass though from Tiedemans. It was a great ball, Ian, as you rightly said, but the centre forward, Teo Dorchik, didn't quite believe in himself. He's got so many goals for Anderlecht this season, as you've previously said, but he was one on one. It was a great block from Valencia, but he just didn't have the conviction to go and stick it in the back of the net.
Ibrahimovic, Mkhitaryan going on the overlap outside Rashford. He plays the ball in towards Shaw. Good running by Shaw, across the face of goal, and just wide. Excellent running from the England left back.
Oh, and Lingard was a fraction from it. It was a great run from Luke Shaw. He burst into the box. Rashford found him with a perfectly weighted pass, and then Shaw smashes it across the box. You almost think that Lingard's going to touch it in. He touches the ball, Lingard, but I think it was Spajic who put Lingard off. What an opportunity. Oh, how did he miss that, Lingard? 1 yard out, gets his studs on it, but it goes inches past the far post.
Thing is, from an Anderlecht point of view, if they wanted to do it, they could just sit back now and frustrate Manchester United and take it to extra time. Chance they'll look at a penalty shootout, who knows. But their tactics don't seem to have changed. They still seem to be as adventurous as ever, which will then leave holes at the back for United to try and take advantage of.
It's been a fantastic game also, Ian. They believe they can go and win this. If they can get that second away goal, oh, now what an uphill task it will be for United then. But as Rashford goes in this left-hand side.
Rashford over the top as he got round the back of Appiah, and it runs out of play for a goal kick. I agree with you. Just get the ball to Rashford.
Yeah, he's been magnificent tonight. When he's had the ball, hasn't had it as often as I'd like, you know. But his combination play, especially in the second half of Luke Shaw, has been very, very good. You know, Luke Shaw, we've just seen the replay on our monitors. It was brilliant play. Took 2-3 touches, and then Lingard, he's a yard out. It's great determination from Lingard to make that run into the middle of the goal, and he does actually get his studs on it, sliding in, and now he's missed that. Very unfortunate.
A roll of the left hand as Mourinho glanced over his left shoulder as he stands in front of us. Zani plays the ball through to Djuricic, and it means that there's going to be a change. I think somebody's just warming up. It's Ashley Young who's been given the instruction to warm up for Manchester United as Schalke are leading Ajax by a goal to nil. But Ajax, of course, are still ahead in the tie following that 2-0 first leg lead in Amsterdam last week. Besiktas 1, Lyon 1, and still no goals in Belgium between Genk and Celta Vigo. Celta Vigo have a 3-2 advantage from the first leg. Radio 5 Live here at Old Trafford. The Europa League quarter-final, second leg, 1-1 on the night, just as it was a week ago. Means it's 2-2 overall, and Mourinho continues to slowly and gently walk and pace that technical area. But Anderlecht, with Dendonka now, can come forward, and hurriedly he's over halfway. Plays the ball up to Akiapong, who gets away from Pogba, this diminutive midfielder. Tielemans joins the attack. Now with Chipchu, Akiapong, central area with his back to goal. Very comfortable, very confident, lays it back to Chipchu, who in the end shoots right-footed from a good 25 yards out from goal and pulls it wide for a goal kick. Robbie Savage.
Yeah, the three Manchester United substitutes have gone to warm up. Rooney, Young, Herrera. You know, Mourinho's in his technical area now having a chat with his assistant. Can we think, could he take Zlatan Ibrahimovic off? We've seen how effective Lingard and Rashford were at the weekend against Chelsea in forward positions. And will he think about taking Ibrahimovic off?
Djuricic couldn't thread it through to Ani, who brought Anderlecht level earlier. Appiah against Rashford. Appiah, though, stands his ground, gets a toe into the challenge, out of play, it goes for a throw. The Manchester United will take with Rashford on this near side, the left, back towards Shaw. As Mkhitaryan comes forward now, looking towards Ibrahimovic, and Brodji, though, just steps forward out of defence with an important intervention for Anderlecht. Anderlecht on the attack, the cross punched away at the near post by Romero. Tielemans gets away from a sliding challenge of Pogba. Tielemans waits the ball out to Chipchus. First time cross comes in. Churicic with a header straight at the goalkeeper Romero.
It's all Anderlecht at the minute. United need to get hold of this game. Pogba needs to get on the ball. So does Michael Carrick. He's got the armband on. Need to get on the ball. Get the ball wide to Lingard, Rashford. It's all Anderlecht at the minute. Worrying signs for Manchester United.
Pogba, forward ball. Ibrahimovic will head it on. The goalkeeper had come a long way and in the end had to dive back to his left hand side to gather that ball in, as Wayne Rooney is being booed. In fact, Fellaini is being booed. Of course, the former Standard Liège player only won one of four encounters with Anderlecht. I thought it was a bit harsh on Rooney, but yeah. Schalke have got a second goal in Germany. Schalke 2, Ajax 0. So, like this one, they've levelled the tie. Schalke 2, Ajax 0, 2-2 on aggregate, just as it is between Manchester United and Anderlecht. Still, Besiktas 1, Lyon 1, Lyon lead 3-2, and that is the same aggregate scoreline between Genk and Celta Vigo. Still 0-0 in Belgium, but Celta Vigo with the advantage from the first leg. Here is Pogba. Bailly, midway through the Anderlecht half. Anderlecht now have dropped off. Everyone behind the ball as Lingard out to Valencia plays it forward, offside against Ibrahimovic. Flag was raised quite early. Robbie Savage.
Fantastic ball from Valencia. You know, in his right back position, he's whipping around the corner into Ibrahimovic's path, but just went a bit too early. Ibrahimovic. It's been a very, very good game. You know, the Anderlecht fans away to our right have been in such good spirits, good noise. You know, United fans are getting behind their side. There's a few worried faces around Old Trafford. Before the game, Ian, you thought it'd be two or three comfortable for United, so did I. It's not turning out that way. They're growing in confidence, Anderlecht. You know, United should have put this bed to tie in Belgium, they haven't.
Pogba takes a deflection and takes it away from Rashford and through towards the goalkeeper. It doesn't matter what division you watch your football, you'll hear the chant of everywhere you go, making all the noise. And it's the Anderlecht supporters who are actually singing that song in English to our right-hand side. And they've travelled in excellent numbers too in that right corner here at Old Trafford. Pogba's forward ball is another aimless one over the head of Ibrahimovic. Didn't give him a chance. And through towards the Spanish goalkeeper, who came as part of a deal that took their previous number one, Rofe, to Deportivo La Coruña, a 32-year-old who began some 13 years ago with just a handful of appearances, in fact three, at Barcelona. He spent all of his career in Spain. And we said about 3-0, 3-1, if it wasn't for his double save in the space of two or three minutes after the Mkhitaryan goal, Manchester United would have already had plenty of daylight between Anderlecht. But he made two excellent saves, and then Anderlecht with the equaliser after 31 minutes. Tielemans, just short of the halfway line as Anderlecht play from left to right. Headed away though by the right back Valencia. Picked up by Den Donker. Coming forward now. Out to Akiapong. Forward ball. And the cross is going to be gathered in by Romero. And he can't release it to anybody.
I wouldn't be surprised if we see Fellaini come on, you know, for Manchester United. The big question is who will come off. Will it be Carrick? He's got the armband on, not being that instrumental tonight, Michael Carrick. Now, I don't think he'll take Pogba off. Zlatan Ibrahimovic is not having his best game. Looks like Fellaini's getting stripped in. Who will he come on for? That is the big question.
So, Marouane Fellaini, who the Anderlecht supporters have just been booing and cheering. He's getting his final instructions. And I'm sure he would love to get the winning goal to silence them. Zimbodji comes forward, stops in his tracks, gives the ball away. Manchester United now with Pogba. Mkhitaryan overruns it. Tielemans is back there to help out. His clearance takes a deflection, loops up in the air. Tielemans now has got time to come forward. And he loses his balance but releases it to this near side. Chipchu joins the attack. Chipchu into the penalty area. Shot was blocked. That's the worry. A second away goal. And Manchester United will have problems. Pogba 1-1 on the night, comes forward now into the centre circle, held up by Tendonka, rolls the ball out towards Lingard. Lingard with pace, starts to run on his toes, right corner of the area, and it peters out straight out of for a goal kick. Fellaini's coming on, and it's going to be Lingard coming off.
Jesse Lingard coming off, which is a bit of a surprise. You know, what will happen now? Will Pogba push forward to where Mkhitaryan plays? Mkhitaryan go over to that right-hand side. Fellaini go next to Carrick. I think that will probably be the option. As Lingard comes off from that far side. Fellaini coming on, getting boos from the away fans.
Mallow and Fellaini getting a very hostile reception from the Anderlecht supporters. The former Standard Liège player, standing ovation for Lingard. He only won one of his four encounters against Anderlecht when he was with Standard Liège, but Fellaini is on. And that's the second of the three substitutions made by Jose Mourinho.
Looks like Mkhitaryan's gone on to that right-hand side. Fellaini next to Carrick. You know, Pogba pushed one on. He's now playing in behind Zlatan Ibrahimovic. Mkhitaryan and Rashford alongside him.
This then is with Appiah, right-hand side. Anderlecht making a change as well. Chipchu loses out though to Rashford, who's back there helping out in defensive duties. He's everywhere, Marcus Rashford. And when Mourinho's talking about Martial, and effectively he's saying, I can trust Marcus Rashford. He gives you everything. He gets back, he'll track back, he'll do the dirty work, as well as going forward and giving you always an option. So Anderlecht are going to be making their first change. René Weiler, the 43-year-old coach, is in his first season at the club after the last two seasons being in Germany with Nuremberg, and what a scalp he could potentially take here against Manchester United. But it's still 1-1, but it's finally poised. 61 minutes played, and going to be Chipchu is going to be coming off, I think, and we're going to be seeing Bruno coming onto the field of play. Massimo Bruno is a 23-year-old forward, so they're not necessarily going to try and shore things up. Going to be like for like, I would imagine, but it's going to be a double change as well, as Pogba will come striding forward from midfield. Stanciu is also going to be coming on. Here's Ibrahimovic for Manchester United. Ibrahimovic to Pogba, tries to wriggle free into the penalty area. Excellent challenge made. Rashford tried to dart back into the penalty area, but it'll be Chipchu to bring it away. Pogba then holds him off. Rashford in field. Fellaini to Ibrahimovic, still 1-1. Right-hand side. Valencia held up by Akia Pong. In comes the cross. Fellaini was there. Nobody following up. There was Rashford on the edge of the area. Charge down, and the ball goes behind for a corner kick. 1-1.
Yeah, Fellaini on. He's in the middle of the goal. Went for the header. Good defending from Spajic. Ball falls to Rashford, one bounce volley, then Dunker with a block, better from United.
62 minutes played, still all to play for. Mkhitaryan from the cross towards the far post, Fellaini's downward header, gathered in by a swivelling goalkeeper. And now the change can be made, and we're going to see Sofyan Anni going off. And the other player will be coming off will be Alexandra Trippchu. So they are the two changes that will be made. Very helpful of the fourth official to get two electronic boards and already have the numbers up. And whilst I was reading that out, I think it was a case of what we'd said, wasn't it? Stanciu for Chipchu, and the other change was Bruno for Sofyan Anni.
I'm surprised Annie's come off, the captain. I thought he's got the goal, he's had a very good game tonight.
Besiktas are back in front against Lyon. Besiktas 2, Lyon 1, 3-3 on aggregate. And Genk 0, Celta Vigo 1. That means Celta Vigo now have a 4-2 advantage on aggregate. Remember, it's Schalke 2, Ajax 0, which is 2-2 overall, as it is here, 2-2 overall, because it's 1-1 on the night. The Europa League on the BBC. 64 minutes played here at Old Trafford. So Manchester United are looking for the goal to take them back in front of a tie that Jose Mourinho will certainly bemoan his misfortune Wasted opportunities, call it what you will, in front of goal if they do not take the chances. Here is Rashford. Rashford shoots just wide. Of course, it was this competition last year in February against Midtjylland where he made his name in dramatic circumstances. It opened up for him there on the edge of the area, right-footed, pulled it wide. Goal kick.
Well, great ball from Pogba in the middle of the park, left foot, diagonal to Ibrahimovic. He pulled onto Appiah. He won the ball. He nodded down to Rashford, who drove inside, and then it just opened up for him. He's 18 yards out. He tried to give the goalkeeper the eyes. He started dragging that near post. Probably should have opened his body and gone for that far post. Good opportunity there for Rashford.
Ruben, the keeper gets away from Ibrahimovic, but his ball is picked up in the centre circle by Pogba. Manchester United, red shirts, white shorts, playing from right to left. Valencia, infield to Carrick, the Manchester United captain. Alongside him is Fellaini. There's the boos and the whistles for the former Standard Liège player. Shaw, back towards Carrick. Plenty of red shirts forward, but that was easily read by Dendonka. And then it was with Stanciu, who'll come forward now on this this near side. Ball played forward, Čuričić. Čuričić then fouled by Fellaini. Needless foul to give away. Just a little tug back there at the Polish international. And Fellaini gives away the free kick to Anderlecht.
Yeah, as you say, and needless foul there from Fellaini. And Teodorčić. Opportunity now for Tielemans to put the ball in the box. Centre-halves are going forward, and Bodzi Spajic.
66 minutes played, still 1-1. Tielemans goes deep, and Romero will gather that in. Two-handed, high above his head, in the six-yard area. Can't release the ball, though. Eventually he does. It's a long clearance down towards Rashford. Appiah was tucked in the right back to head it forward. And the ball is stroked forward then by Tielemans towards Bruno. Comes out of play. Out of play by Blint, gives it away to an Anderlecht throw-in. Wayne Rooney warming up, as is Herrera just in front of us. Wayne Rooney, who's hardly figured of late, the combination of not being selected and also problems with his ankles. Appiah with the throw for Anderlecht on this right-hand side. They're playing from left to right towards the fair-haired Čuričić. And then it's with Pogba, who'll win a throw for Manchester United off the legs of the Polish striker. Well, when the games continue to come thick and fast, and he's already said that he had to rest a few players because of tiredness, such as being this grueling schedule, the last thing that Jose Mourinho will want, and this is the game 6 of 9 in a 30 day period, is an additional 30 minutes.
Yeah, possibly, but you alluded to before the game the strength in depth. Look at the bench: Rooney, Martial, Blind, Young, Herrera, Fellaini. That was the bench that started for Manchester United. So yes, they've got a few injuries defensively.
Genk have equalised at home to Celta Vigo, 1-1 on the night, as Anderlecht will come forward. Celta Vigo, though, lead 4-3 on aggregate. Stanciu up against Fellaini, will win a corner as well. Fellaini couldn't keep the ball in despite his best efforts, stretching all to no avail. So Anderlecht playing from left to right, have a corner on that far side, the left, with 22 minutes remaining of normal time. It's 9:30. Radio 5 live. And the Anderlecht supporters are in anticipation. In comes the corner, stabbed away by Valencia. Edge of the box, cleared by Mkhitaryan. Rashford's got to go it alone. Appiah's missed control. Appiah has let in Rashford. Rashford to steal it for Manchester United. Around the goalkeeper, the angle is tight. The angle is still tight. Appiah gets back there. And Appiah will dispossess Rashford inside the penalty area. Ibrahimovic then closes him down. And what an opportunity that was for United.
Oh, Rashford, he's done so well. Great tenacity, great desire. He won the ball off Appiah. Appiah tried to pull him back. He stayed on his feet. He's one-on-one with Ruben, went round the keeper. His touch was a little bit too heavy, forced him to the byline, and then Appiah got back and made the challenge. What an opportunity for Rashford.
Here is Fellaini. Manchester United will come again. Valencia, however, it's not wave and wave of pressure from Manchester United, as Valencia will send over the cross now, aimed towards Fellaini, headed away by Mbodge. Jose Mourinho talked in the programme notes about his players and what that wing would have done against Chelsea. He also talked about the atmosphere, but he wanted the same tonight. It hasn't really been like that tonight inside Old Trafford. However, They do have a corner kick. It's an outswinger from the right-hand side. Pogba tried to meet it with the acrobatics. Rashford's miscontrolled it and cleared away by Mbodge inside that penalty area. Headed away by Valencia. Potential break still on though for Anderlecht. Tielemans will bring it forward. Tries to switch play. Akiapong. There's a man over. Teodosic is joining the attack. Akiapong will go central. Takes a shot off his left foot. Takes a deflection and loops behind for a corner. Still 1-1.
Yeah, Blind and Valencia, I think, got in each other's way. Went for the same ball. Ball eventually fell to Akiapong, who took a strike and Shaw with a good challenge. It was dipping over Romero's bar. Corner Anderlecht.
This is the only scoreline where we could still have extra time and penalties. Anderlecht, though, got a corner kick. Tielemans to take it. He curls it in. Romero, though, confident take again. Two-handed above his head. But there was nobody to throw the ball out to. He looked. And eventually he hurls it long, just short of the halfway line to Pogba. But there was no natural width for Manchester United on the left-hand side. Pogba's searching ball over the head of Mkhitaryan. Out towards the corner flag on the right-hand side. Attacking the Stretford end. Valencia provides the support. The right back with the cross. Fellaini's there. Forced to Ibrahimovic! Blocked. The flag had stayed down as well. Just couldn't chip it goalwards. Break on now. Game's end to end. Anderlecht are certainly not parking the bus. If anything, they're driving this purple bus forward. Here is Stanciu. Now out towards Bruno on this near side to right. Manchester United have everybody back in field. Back to the Romanian Stanciu. Appiah joins the attack. The right back is high up on this pitch level, the penalty area. He now makes a run in towards the penalty area. Bruno, though, will win a throw. Good defending by Shaw.
What a game we've got. End-to-end stuff. It was Fellaini causing all kinds of havoc. Valencia with the ball in. Fellaini with a late run. He just got a little nick on it. Fell to Ibrahimovic 6 yards out on his right foot. But what a save from Rubens. And then Anderlecht the tech. What a game we've got here.
Pogba brings the ball clear. Left corner of his own penalty area. Infield to Mkhitaryan. Back towards Fellaini. Along the ground, Carrick is caught from behind. Quickly back onto his feet, he springs. The referee enables that quick free kick to be taken. Pogba now in front of Mourinho on this near side, the left. Plays it forward. Flag stays down. Ibrahimovic into the penalty area. Goes down under a challenge. The referee says no.
There was a ball from Pogba. Wonderful ball. It was Spajic on Ibrahimovic. You know, Zlatan was... Oh.
Now from the other end, Teodosic, and in the end it's clawed away by Romero, who's out of his penalty area and has to clear, clatters it right-footed, it's end-to-end at the moment.
Oh, it's brilliant here, in the quarter-final, but that chance for Ibrahimovic, it was Pogba with his left foot over the top, the ball seemed to get stuck between Ibrahimovic's legs, and then did Spajic pull him over, he appealed for the penalty, the referee was right on the spot.
Akiapong latches on to a flick header by Teodosic. Inside now to Stanciu. Stanciu outside the penalty area. Valencia will pop it forward. Mkhitaryan heads it infield. Carrick helps it on its way to Pogba. Outside the centre circle. He's faced by Tielemans. He'll look to outstretch him. Pogba shows his strength but plays the ball behind Rashford. Left corner of the penalty area. Rashford just in from the touchline now to Pogba. Caught in possession. And Tielemans will bring the ball away to Akiapong. Obradovic goes on the overlap, and here he is, just short of the halfway line, back towards the Ghanaian. Infield now, and Anderlecht, they've been very composed and on the ball, haven't they, throughout the whole evening?
Yeah, you've got to say, but United have had two massive chances in the last 10 minutes. First, Rashford, one-on-one with the goalkeeper, should have scored, and then Ibrahimovic forced a great save from Rubens. But Anderlecht, look a threat on the counter-attack. You know, while one's left, 15, 16 minutes, I want extra time, is that good?
But the thing is, with 16 minutes remaining, and Anderlecht were to score a second away goal, time would be very much against Manchester United then, because they would need two more. And we're entering that stage where it might just start to get a little jittery here at Old Trafford. Pogba. The importance of this game cannot be underestimated, because Manchester United still want to be competing on dual fronts in order to get into the Champions League for next season. And of course, the added incentive of silverware in this Europa League. But at the moment, they're struggling to try and break down this Anderlecht side as Spajic gives the ball away after stepping out of defence. And Bailly midway through his own half will unchallenged retrieve that ball. On that occasion, nobody went after Bailly. It was almost as if Anderlecht this time have sat back. Carrick to Pogba. Carrick's forward of the centre circle. Fellaini ventures forward. Valencia provides the width on that far side to right. Attacking the Stretford end. Valencia's cross, left-footed. Fellaini's in there. Takes a deflection off an Anderlecht player. And Ibrahimovic is quite happy to let it run behind for a corner kick.
Yeah, Fellaini's picking up some good positions. He's driving from that midfield role. He's making late runs. He's causing panic in the Anderlecht defence. Even if he's not winning the ball, they're worried where he is.
15 minutes remain. Corner kick left-hand side. Rashford to take it in towards the near post. Volleyed away by Tielemans on the corner of that six-yard box. Quickly taken by Rashford. Mkhitaryan comes under pressure from behind by Bruno. Bruno actually will win that decision. And the referee tried to play the advantage, but there wasn't to be an advantage to be played, so in the end he's given a free kick to Anderlecht. And I think that Rennie Weiler, their coach, is contemplating a change himself. 1-1. Not many people would have predicted this at this stage of the evening. The ball is played long towards Akiapong, takes it high on the chest on the edge of the area. The referee tells the Ghanaian to get to his feet.
No, it was great tracking from Valencia. Match Akiapong's run inch for inch. Good strength.
Fellaini to Carrick, outside the centre circle of his own half. High ball lifted towards Pogba. Pogba's header comes towards Ibrahimovic. Ibrahimovic now enters the penalty area, stretching, still tussling for the ball. Will come off Appiah and goes out of play for a Manchester United throw on this near side, the left, that Shaw will take quickly. Shaw with a throw to Ibrahimovic, tries to shield the ball away from Mbodji, but Mbodji will clip it out of play. No, it doesn't go out of play. It's kept in by Rashford. Rashford does the step over. Excellent play by Rashford with the cross. Tucks in was the left back. No, in fact, it was Spajic, the central defender, with an important header clear for Anderlecht. The pressure remains. Shaw to take it to the feet of Rashford on this near touchline. Rashford can't thread it in field. Ball comes back towards Michael Carrick. It goes out of play that Carrick will want to take himself. Anderlecht have dropped everybody behind the ball bar Tjuricuk. Here now is Carrick just inside the Anderlecht half. 13 minutes remaining. Carrick looks towards Fellaini. Fellaini heads it infield. Here is Ibrahimovic. Pogba stretching, tries to head it back in towards the penalty area, and Anderlecht now will clear. Obradovic though can't control it. It's a United throw. Now all of a sudden they're starting to pen Anderlecht back.
Yeah,
in.
Yeah, good pressure from United. They're getting the ball to Rashford more. His link-up play was shown this left-hand side is very good. Carrick's getting the ball, putting passes together. Fellaini's made an impact since he's come on, making late runs into the box. Can they get the good delivery?
Rashford with a cross. The goalkeeper came for it, and Mbodji also went for it as well. And the central defender has headed the ball behind for a corner kick. A breakdown in communication. They're going to be making a change. Tjuricuk is going to be coming off, but for the time being, the Polish striker has gone back to help out. It's going to be like for like. Thelin's going to be coming on. The Swedish striker has just started to become a little bit isolated, though, as the Polish forward. In comes the corner now. Pogba from close range. And he's blazed the ball over from inside the six-yard box. Over the bar. What a chance.
What a chance. It's a great delivery from Mkhitaryan. The outswinger, it's landed in the six-yard box. Pogba's got away from his marker. Obradovic on the volley. He has to hit the target from there. Great opportunity. Must put that in the back of it. Another chance for Manchester United. They should be winning this game.
But they're not. And we're 12 minutes away from the possibility of extra time. Here at Old Trafford. 1-1 on the night, 2-2 on aggregate. Here is Stanciu running into a cul-de-sac, puts a little bit of pressure on Mbodji, back with the goalkeeper Ruben, who will clear only as far as Fellaini. Early ball from Fellaini goes straight back towards Mbodji on the edge of his penalty area. Pogba to Rashford, infield to Mkhitaryan. Well read by the defender Spajic.
Got to say, Anderlecht have looked poor since the captain and he's gone off. You know, I'm not sure if he's injured, but it was a weird change for me. And since that, United have been in total domination, had a couple of good chances. They should be winning this game, United.
Spajic with a late challenge on Mkhitaryan. And it means that will be a free kick to Manchester United. 11 minutes remaining of normal time. Blint will place the ball down. It's 6 yards forward of the centre circle, central position. Bruno's just been told to go forward. He'll take Shaw with him. And in fact, Bailly will also venture back too to keep an eye on the Anderlecht player. Everybody else is back in purple helping out. Valencia, right side of the penalty area with the cross. Ibrahimovic screws it well wide. Well wide off his right foot. Goal kick.
But you see Valencia's pushed forward. You know, they've got Fellaini, Rashford, Pogba, Ibrahimovic in the box. Ball's into the box. Now, I wouldn't say Anderlecht are hanging on, but they've, as you've said rightly, and they've dropped deeper. The changes have been made. You know, if there's at this minute in time, there's going to be a winner, you'll think it'd be Manchester United. Good pressure. They're pinning Anderlecht back. They haven't got an out ball. But can they get that winner in normal time?
They lack that killer instinct, Manchester United, this season. You think about how many times they've drawn. What was it, 12 in the Premier League? They can't finish teams off, can they?
They've had three, four very good chances in the second half. You know, Rashford 1-1, Ibrahimovic. The foul there from Shaw.
On Bruno. Free kick to Anderlecht. 9.5 minutes remaining.
You could just hear the crowd go silent. The Old Trafford crowd, was it 75,000 in here tonight? You can see they're a bit worried because all it needs is, you know, good delivery. Somebody lose their marker.
Tielemans is going to take this free kick for Anderlecht in their purple kit, playing from left to right. Right footed now, straight down the throat of Romero. But again, how many times has Romero caught the ball and not had options to throw it out to? In the end, it's towards Valencia. Back with Pogba. Pogba holds off Dendonka. Plays the ball square. Midway through his own half, Valencia towards Bailly. Bailly at the heart of the United defence. Diagonal ball along the ground now with Carrick, just outside the centre circle. Edging their way towards the halfway line. Here is Fellaini. Back with Pogba. Bailly. You wouldn't believe, judging where they're stroking the ball around, that there are 9 minutes remaining. Carrick. Oh, it opens up for Carrick. Carrick continues to come forward into Ibrahimovic, and again he screwed it wide. He teed it up for himself off his right foot. Swings his boot in annoyance at the turf with his frustration boiling over. It was another good opportunity, but it was another wasteful play, squandered once more.
Great play from Carrick. He drove into the space and Bodgy had to come out and go to Carrick, therefore left the space for Ibrahimovic to run into. One touch out of his feet on his right foot, got at the target, puts it wide. Good chance once again.
Valencia, right hand side for Manchester United, still one apiece on the night, 2-2 on aggregate. Right corner of the penalty area, over the cross, headed away by Appia. Ibrahimovic lays it off towards Shaw. Shaw, first time ball in, the goalkeeper, good take coming off his line, confident goalkeeping.
Well, lucky he hits out quickly.
Good distribution.
Yeah.
Finds Akiapong. Akiapong up against Bailly, but Bailly will not be outstripped. And he's struggling with cramp now, is Akiapong. He's gone down. It's only cramp. Play on. Yeah, it's only cramp. Anderlecht won the ball, put out of play. It's clearly cramp. The Anderlecht supporters are whistling. Ball goes up to Ibrahimovic and a downward header gathered in. Now if you want the ball put out, you put it out. Which eventually they'll do. Eventually. From the goalkeeper.
Oh, what a second half. What a game this has been, to be fair.
7 minutes remain of normal time.
United again. Well, they missed so many chances in the second half. Once again, you know, that's the story of their season here at Old Trafford, isn't it? We've seen goalkeepers playing exceptionally well. You know, Tom Heaton's performance, Grant's performance to Stoke. You know, so many keepers have come here and played well. Ruben tonight has been exceptional for Anderlecht. You know, we're seeing the chances missed on our monitor in front of us. Zlatan's had two great ones in the second half. Rashford 1-1 with the goalkeeper. Is it going to be one of those nights where they miss chances once again here at Old Trafford? They've had so many. Anderlecht second half have offered very little, created a few chances in that first half, but is it going to be one of those nights?
And when we talk about Manchester United potentially winning this competition, is that because we're going on the name of Manchester United? Because this, if they are to win, this will be a hard-fought victory against a side that they've already accounted for Rostov and Saint-Étienne, who Anderlecht couldn't beat earlier in Europe.
Well, if United win this competition, they'll deserve it. You know, it's a European competition. Let's be fair here. In the second half, the chances they created, they should be two or three up. They've missed very, very good opportunities. Ruben, the goalkeeper, has been fantastic for Anderlecht. You know, okay, they had a couple of chances in the first half, Anderlecht, but it's been all United this second half. They should be winning this game. They just got to take one of those chances. Story of the season.
5.5 minutes remain. Akir Pong, after his cramp, is okay. Mind you, we've got no choice. There's no other substitutions to be made. As the ball is hoisted towards Ibrahimovic, they're appealing for handball. The referee, Mayenko, was perfectly placed to say it wasn't. Now here it is with Bruno, just short of the halfway line. It's a forward ball that is dealt with by Flint up towards Ibrahimovic, infield towards Pogba, who comes forward, urged on, finds Rashford, offside, flag was raised. He goes on to put the ball in the back of the net.
I tell you what, he tried to halt his run there, Rashford, as well. You know, he was offside, then he tried to get back onside and bend his run. You're just going to see on our monitors now, it was hold up play from Ibrahimovic. He wanted the ball earlier. I've got to say, he's onside. We're just seeing the replays now. Spiat stepped out, but Rashford was in an onside position. Poor decision from the linesman.
It remains 1-1 with 4.5 minutes of normal time remaining. Jose Mourinho has a little swig of liquid refreshment from one of the bottles that's just to the right of the technical area, with his overcoat, watching on.
I've got to say, though, Ian, if it does go to extra time, United look the fitter, stronger, more dynamic side.
It's 30 minutes, though, that he will not want in this grueling fixture of games. This is the 54th game of the campaign. Chelsea, the leaders, have only played 39, although Chelsea will know all about what it takes out of a side when you can go on and maybe win the Europa League, because Chelsea in 2013... actually played 69 matches during that campaign. Potentially, United could only have a further 10 more to come. But it's 1-1. Anderlecht have a free kick, just short of the halfway line. Bailly with a header, forward towards Fellaini. Brings it under control and back towards Mkhitaryan. Now with Valencia, the right back. Valencia goes long. Ibrahimovic with a flick header. Stopped though by Mbodji's outstretched leg. Back in the Manchester United half. Five live with Blint to Bailly. If we are to go into extra time at the end of the regulation 90, we'll bring you more news on that breaking story of the shots fired and sadly fatalities on the Champs-Élysées in Paris. Pogba to Fellaini. Shaw. Rashford on this near side, the left. Rashford looking to attack Appiah. Appiah though stands forward, gets the foot in, out of play, it goes for a throw. Rashford will take it back to his England colleague Luke Shaw. 2.5 minutes of normal time remaining. Blint to Bailly. The Anderlecht supporters are making the noise to our right.
In the four thinking areas for Anderlecht, the changes haven't been that good, that positive. You know, they've offered little going forward. You know, I know we're what, minute and a half left till extra time, but I think Anderlecht's best opportunity of getting through here is taking United to penalties. As I've just said, they look strong, they're creating chances, they look powerful, United. You know, and Anderlecht going forward in the second half have offered very little.
I think, like you said as well, they've missed the presence of Annie, haven't they, since he went off. But they're being urged on just to keep going for these last few minutes. Mkhitaryan to Pogba. At the moment, United can't find a way through. Fellaini, right-footed, goes long into the penalty area, off the chest of Ibrahimovic. Stepping forward, though, is Mbodji. And Bruno now will wait, and Bruno runs in field. Shaw will try and stick with him. Picks out Stanciu, another of the substitutes. Drilled clearance is blocked, then lifted forward by Spajic. Flying header forward by Bailly. He must have only been a matter of inches off the ground. Mkhitaryan now comes away on the right-hand side, waits. The pass to Pogba, asked a lot of Pogba, he did well. Mkhitaryan, Pogba is there, with his back to goal is Ibrahimovic, scrims it to Rashford, into the side netting, and it's still 1-1.
Oh, it's another chance, it's great play from Ibrahimovic, he's peeled off, he's on the edge of the area, centre of goal, Rashford with a late run the left-hand side, Ibrahimovic flicks in between the two defenders, what is he, 6 yards out, tight angle, decides to smash it with his left foot. hits the side netting, but it's another chance. Can he go? He's got to go for the far post there, Ian. He's got to smash it across. Another chance for United.
By my watch, we have 60 seconds remaining of normal time, and it's still Manchester United 1, Anderlecht 1, which means it's 2-2 in aggregate, and extra time is looming. Pogba to Mkhitaryan. Mkhitaryan outside the centre circle. There's a 360-degree turn, held off, though, by Tielemans. Appiah then will help out his, now the captain, sporting the armband. Appiah continues his run. It opens up for Appiah. He then runs into Luke Shaw. Oh, the bounce of the ball is to Steve Valencia. Akiapong now. This could be it, as if it was a goal now for Anderlecht. Akiapong does the little step over. Left corner of the penalty area. But Manchester United, with Bailly, will deal with that danger. Towards Ibrahimovic. Gets a little knock in the face, does he? The referee, though, says no. Plays the advantage sign, which says that Ibrahimovic was maybe fouling Spajic. Now, Obradovic comes forward, the left back. Links up. Goes to ground. Won the ball, Manchester United. Now with Mkhitaryan. How much added on time will there be? The fourth official so absorbed in the game, he's forgotten to get the electronic board ready. By my watch, the 90 minutes have already elapsed. Little glance at his own watch and 2 minutes, which we're now into. Carrick forward. Rashford makes the run in off the left touchline. Appiah had gone with him. We've raved about Rashford, but Appiah, I tell you, he's had a fine game at right back, particularly in the second half.
Yeah, their goalkeeper's been their best player, though. And he was until he got taken off. But the goalkeeper for Anderlecht has pulled off some fantastic saves. And United have missed so many chances once again.
Here is Pogba, back with Valencia. Mkhitaryan. Mkhitaryan into the penalty area. Ball in the air, off the chest by Ibrahimovic. The angle's tight. Inside left channel of the penalty area. Pulls it back towards Rashford. In towards Shaw. Excellent block coming in. Shaw actually went for the ball. And he's gone down, and there's also an Anderlecht defender down as well. He had a wild swing, didn't he?
Tell you what, what's happened is Luke Shaw's made a good run. He hasn't seen Spajic, and he's gone to whack the ball in from 6 yards. He hasn't seen Spajic. Spajic has made a fantastic block, and Luke Shaw has smashed the bottom of Spajic's boots. But thankfully for Luke Shaw, he's getting up, running back to the left-back position. Great challenge from Spajic there.
Luke Shaw, this is only his fifth appearance for Manchester United since the end of November. He's running back into his position now at left back. I'm just trying to shake it off for Manchester United. Of course, it was his hamstring that he picked up at the end of November against West Ham United. As Manchester United, by my watch, the 2 minutes have added on time are all but over. Last throw of the dice. Good ball goes long. Ibrahimovic goes down. He landed awkwardly, Ibrahimovic. That's and nasty. Manchester United could have problems here because Ibrahimovic, as the full-time whistle sounds, landed very, very awkwardly to that high ball.
That's so nasty.
The final whistle has sounded. It's Manchester United 1, Anderlecht 1. We now have extra time because it's finished 2-2 on aggregate, but plenty of concern now for Ibrahimovic the way that he fell.
Yeah, he's the long ball, he's trying to chest it, and he's landed. His knee seemed to get trapped underneath him. That looks very, very nasty indeed for Ibrahimovic. We're seeing the replay now. It's a ball from Carrick. He controls the ball, and as he lands, oh, it just seemed to land so awkwardly there. Oh, his right knee.
So Ibrahimovic is continuing to being treated. We've got extra time to come, but of course on 5 Live we're also keeping you abreast of that developing story in Paris. But here in the football, we'll be back with extra time. It's finished 2-2 on aggregate. And the news is, as far as Ibrahimovic is concerned, as extra time is underway, the first period here on Radio 5, is that at least the stretcher wasn't required. It did look extremely bad for the Swedish international, but he was able to walk off down the tunnel, albeit extremely gingerly, and he has been replaced by Martial. So both sides now have used all of their substitutions. 1-1 on the night, 2-2 on aggregate. We're into the first period of extra time. Robbie Savage.
Yeah, nasty looking injury for Ibrahimovic. You know, Rojo's already gone off with a knee injury. You know, and that looked another nasty one for Zlatan. Seemed to hyper-extend his knee when he landed. Looked very uncomfortable.
So Manchester United in this first period, in their red shirts, white shorts and white socks, are playing from left to right. I'll run through the two teams again for you. As Fellaini, one of the substitutes, goes down in a challenge with Obradovic, the Serbian left-back. And in fact, he's holding his shoulder, I think, is Fellaini, as it goes out of play for a throw. Now, they've used all three substitutes, but he's in a lot of pain at the moment. Romero's in goal. Valencia, Bailly, Blint and Shaw. Fellaini, Carrick and Pogba. Martial, Mkhitaryan and Rashford. That's the Manchester United side. Fellaini's okay to continue. Rashford, right-hand side, checks back. Oh, super cross. Overhead kick, blocked by Spajic. That was would have been a wonderful goal.
Brilliant from Rashford. It was a Rabona into the box after he went past two players. The Rabona to Pogba with a bicycle kick. Oh, and it was hit Spajic, I think, as you rightly said, Ian. 2 yards out. What a goal. What a piece of skill that was.
As any of you who would testify, if you've got a teenage son, they'd just say Tekkers. Because the cross came in and it was Spajic with the block. But it was an outrageous cross, and it would have been an outrageous goal for Pogba. But it's still 1-1. The Anderlecht side, Rubens in goal, Apaya, Spajic and Bodji Obradovic. As here is Mkhitaryan. Mkhitaryan shot. I think he might have took a deflection, looked up in the air, took a little pace off the ball and gathered in by the goalkeeper. Tielemans, Dendonka, and they've also made changes. So they've got Akia Pong on the left, Stanciu on the right, Bruno on the right, and Stanciu in behind Isaac Thelin, who's a Swedish striker, not with the same pulling power as Ibrahimovic would if they were to reach the final for Stockholm on the 24th of May. He's on loan from Bordeaux, and he's only scored one goal in his 14 appearances so far. As Bruno wriggles free in all purple, playing from right to left, and the shot takes a deflection, and that might go for a corner.
Obradovic there, he's allowed to run 30-40 yards forward. He hits a left footed shot across Romero. I think he'd come off a Anderlecht player. Well, no, but he's given a corner.
Originally he signalled a goal kick.
He's actually come off Thielen, I think, as Obradovic strikes it. Yeah, it's come off Thielen's head. It should have been a goal kick to United, not a corner.
So a corner kick to Anderlecht, still 1-1. Manchester United cannot afford to concede a second away goal. The corner is pulled out, and in the end it was a deliberate effort towards Stanciu, right-footed, just inside the penalty area, quite central, off-target goal kick that Romero's going to take.
Well worked corner, actually. Stanciu started on the back post, and then he pulled out, run towards the penalty spot, everybody running on Romero. The corner was pulled back to the penalty spot, and Stanciu was a good opportunity, that. Got underneath the ball, lifted high and wide.
Mentioned before about Manchester United's only previous quarter-final, where they lost on a penalty shootout to Videoton in 84-85, and you still cannot discount a penalty shootout at the moment here on 5 Live. As Fellaini to Pogba. Comes forward now, attacking the end away to our right-hand side. Valencia back with a French international. Rashford is there if he wants him, but Pogba's given the ball away.
But won it back
against Thelin. Thelin dawdled on the ball too much. Carrick now in the centre circle. Out towards Shaw on that far side. Shaw can't find a way around the back, so he has to go back. Manchester United being a little bit more patient here now. Of course, cautious would be a better word.
Yeah, and Rashford's playing more central. You know, Martial's gone onto that left-hand side. You know, Fellaini's playing quite high up as well. At times, he's playing next to Marcus Rashford.
The vocal backing from the Anderlecht supporters as Blint. Manchester United not going anywhere. They're playing in the middle area of the field. Anderlecht have everybody back behind the ball. Pogba looking for that movement, that penetration, which at the moment is lacking. And some of the Manchester United supporters are starting to get frustrated. Then they go long. And it comes off the head of Spajic. Obradovic will clear the left back. Carrick will head it forward. Picked up though by Stanciu. Not able to pick off Manchester United though, as Bailly steps forward. And now with Mkhitaryan. And it looked, oh, excellent play as he glides his way through the Anderlecht midfield. And it required some excellent defending from Mbodji. to curb the presence of Marcus Rashford inside that penalty area.
Brilliant from Mkhitaryan, goes past two, three players, middle of the park, and then Rashford's run, you rightly say it, and Bodgy covered it well, but that's the threat of Rashford. Playing as a number nine, he makes some darn little runs, and players will look for him.
This wasn't in the script for Manchester United. Extra time, Mkhitaryan floats over the corner, headed away by Mbodji. Rashford, who's been the bright spark throughout, though he too has also wasted opportunities as he's taken out there over on that far side. That was by Appiah, and that will be a yellow card.
Well, that's one way to stop Marcus Rashford. He's been brilliant tonight. I think he's been United's best player once again. Stands Appiah up, moves the ball, and Appiah just smashes him. Gives away a free kick. Good position for Manchester United on the far side.
So Manchester United still locked 1-1 with Anderlecht, and we're into extra time. And they have a free kick, left-hand side of the penalty area. 3 or 4 yards up from the byline. Rashford's going to take it. Carrick's there, Fellaini, Pogba, Martial, Bailly also. And it comes, Fellaini's header. With the block coming in from one of the defenders who jumped with him. And now it's with Bruno over on that far side for Anderlecht, midway through his own half, hanging onto the ball, can't pick out Tielemans. And tiredness maybe, and fatigue for Anderlecht, because they're certainly starting to sit a lot deeper and inviting Manchester United onto them. As Valencia pulls and screws his cross out of play for a goal kick, still 1-1.
Great ball from Rashford. He just whipped it into the 6-yard box in the centre of the goal. Fellaini's got to win that header. It was Spajic with a fantastic headed block. But Fellaini, he has to be show more conviction there. He rolls above Spajic. Got to do better there, Fellaini.
When you think back over the course of the game, Spajic is his reading of the game. He's made some vital, vital blocks.
Yeah. But in the 90 minutes, United with a better side, they should have been out of sight with the chances. Martial goes forward. Now Rashford.
Rashford, the ball got stuck underneath his foot there, and he couldn't bring it forward, further forward for Manchester United. As now Anderlecht will break. Tielemans out towards Akiapong. Akiapong on this near side, the left. Valencia shows him on the outside. He passes the ball on the inside, and there was Pogba to Mkhitaryan. Square ball for Fellaini, short of the halfway line. Out towards that far side, and Martial. Martial now running on that left side in the inside of one challenge. Back with Carrick midway through the Anderlecht half to Pogba. Anderlecht though have got all 10 players back behind the ball, and Manchester United now with Valencia floats over a diagonal cross into the penalty area. The direction was towards Fellaini. Shaw will keep it alive, left hand side. Shaw clips over the cross, headed away again by Spajic, the Serbian international. Fellaini with his back to goal, forced away from the penalty area. Manchester United, every outfield player is in the half away to our right-hand side. 9 minutes played in the first period of extra time, still 1-1. Pogba looks to go on the outside of Obradovic, and he'll win a corner off the legs of the Serbian left-back.
Yeah, they look fitter, they look stronger. You know, the full-backs are still getting forward, short down that left-hand side that time. Good ball into the box, but Spajic once again with a good header, but it's all United.
He's 23 years of age, he's on loan from Toulouse, previously of Red Star Belgrade, the central defender. Mkhitaryan with a corner, right-footed, floated over, comes out towards Carrick. He tried to clip it on the half-volley square, it was blocked. Potential break for Anderlecht. Stanchu though overruns it straight towards Shaw, who went to meet him in the central area. Manchester United win the ball back. Pogba to Rashford, trying to burst into the penalty area, and Dendonka is back to stop that run. Out of play it goes for a throw, right down by the corner flag, taken by Martial to Shaw.
I'm trying to give you a break here, Ian.
Manchester United are not allowing any break in play. Carrick to Martial, short sleeves, wearing gloves, stands over the cross. Fellaini's header! Pogba arriving, but the referee's blown his whistle. And the goal is ruled out, and it is still 1-1. And that decision is greeted by a smiling Jose Mourinho.
And I tell you what, I think the referee's got it right. So the ball's to the back post. It's Fellaini, I think he's climbing all over Spiat. Yeah, I think that's the right decision. Fair play to Pogba. He's got in and put the ball in the net. But I think Fellaini jumps on Spiat, leans on him. I think that's probably just about the right call from the referee.
11 minutes into the first period of extra time. Manchester United supporters respond with the defiant chanting of United, United. Jose Mourinho just turned and smiled in the direction of the fourth official after seeing that goal chalked off.
Well, he was very quick to give it to the referee. Difficult one to judge. But Fellaini's caused problems. Yeah, the guy behind the goal, he was right on the spot. Again, it was his side.
But Anderlecht certainly not carrying anywhere near the same level of threat as they did in the first half. That are continuing to frustrate Manchester United.
It was the ball to the back post, wasn't it, Ian? And Fellaini had his both arms on Spiat. That gave him the leverage to get up and win the header. He's been a real threat since he's come on, Fellaini, with some late runs. That time we started in a centre-forward position, peeled to the back post.
Schalke 3, Ajax 0. They've overturned that two-goal deficit, and Ajax are down to 10 men as well. So Schalke lead 3-2 on aggregate. Manchester United coming forward now here in extra time. Rashford running at the heart of the Anderlecht defence to Martial. Martial is forced out a little bit too far wide out on that left-hand side. He'll send the ball in. Fellaini tees up Rashford. First time shot was blocked by Dendonka inside the penalty area. Comes out to Carrick and it goes to the side of Rashford and cleared away by Appiah, the right back, who was quite narrow.
If United don't win this game, they will be absolutely kicking themselves. They've dominated the second half. They've dominated the second half of extra time. Sorry, first half of extra time. They're all over Anderlecht. If they don't win this game, oh, dear me. What will Mourinho have to say? They've battered in Anderlecht.
They're knocking on the door again. Carrick to Mkhitaryan. Feeds the ball out towards Martial. Left-hand side. Appiah makes a well-timed challenge. Out of play it goes for a throw. Again, Mourinho turns away in frustration. Shaw wants to take the throw quickly, but Blin wasn't prepared to venture too far forward from his role as a central defender. So instead he picks out Pogba. Left corner of the penalty area. Back with Pogba with his back to goal. Manchester United playing from left to right. Still 1-1. Pogba with a back heel towards Shaw, but Appiah again was alert, the right back, puts it out of play. It's a throw right down by the corner flag, and by my watch we have 90 seconds remaining of this first period of extra time. Still one apiece. Pogba to Martial, away from the penalty area. Ball back now midway through the Anderlecht half. Bailly first time towards Valencia. Valencia stands over the cross, back forward, header on from Martial, will run into the arms of the Anderlecht goalkeeper, Robbie Savage.
Well, they've got a bit more direct as well in the second half with Fellaini, but they're good balls, they're good quality balls to the big Belgium. He's winning headers, he's bringing people into play. But they've had so many chances to win this game, United. Anderlecht's best opportunity, as I said, in normal time is taking this game to penalties. They've offered... Ooh.
Here is Tielemans. He's going to shoot from long range, and Romero spilt it! Oh, and following up, almost presented an opportunity for Thelin, but then Romero dived on the loose ball.
Oh, it was nearly commentator's curse, wasn't it? They've offered nothing, and then shot. Romero spilled it.
But they have, to be fair, up until then, offered very little. But that would have certainly changed the dynamic of the tie. Still 1-1, 2-2 on aggregate. And Anderlecht now in the closing stages of this first period of extra time. The only tie that hasn't gone to extra time is the one in Belgium, where Celta Vigo, after finishing 1-1 on the night, have gone through 4-2 overall. And they await the three other sides to join them in the last four. But do not rule out a penalty shootout, as the first period of extra time is finished here at Old Trafford. It remains 1-1, and we still remain deadlocked.
Just trying to get a breath. It's been fascinating. It's been brilliant to watch. United once again missing chances. The big controversy in that first period of extra time, the goal ruled out for Pogba. You know, I thought the referee got it right. I thought Fellaini used Spiat to get high in the air. Referee was right on the spot, so was the official behind the goal. But it's been United. They've missed so many chances once again tonight. But Anderlecht, I think their best opportunity in is getting to penalties.
Well, neither side can make any more alterations because they've used their three. Phil Williams might even be delayed further should we have a penalty shootout, because the second half of extra time is about to get underway. So the teams are as you were. Manchester United in their red shirts, white shorts and white socks, now attacking the Stretford end against Anderlecht in their all purple. And Jose Mourinho can only watch on now as the ball is straight back with Romero, with Ruben rather, and Manchester United have given a free kick away, and he's cutting a rather agitated figure now is Jose Mourinho.
Just got to keep doing what they're doing, but just put the ball in the back of the net. That's the only thing missing. They've played with pace, they've played with power, they've created chances. So much pace up there now with Rashford, Martial, Mkhitaryan. Just got to put the ball in the back of the net.
They did have a goal disallowed in that first period of extra time. Goalkeeper hasn't been overly worked though, has he?
He's made three or four good saves in that first half.
Oh, in the first half, yeah.
But and the second half, he's great save from Ibrahimovic. Rashford was one-on-one. You know, the one Lingard from a yard out got his studs to it, went past the post, but huge blow for United losing Rojo and Zlatan Ibrahimovic to, looks like, seriously bad-looking knee injuries.
Blint goes long towards Fellaini, downward header towards Rashford. Rashford! Rashford finds the back of the net! And Rashford, who first made his mark in this competition last season, might well have got the significant goal to take United through to the semi-finals in front of the Stretford end once again in extra time. It's Manchester United 2, Anderlecht 1.
Brilliant goal from Marcus Rashford. The composure, the way he controlled the ball. Then he done a Cruyff turn onto his from his right foot. Set the ball for his left foot and then stroked it past the goalkeeper Rubin. It was a ball from Blind. It was Fellaini causing problems. He won the header. And then a lovely little bit of skill. He's on the penalty spot. A little Cruyff turn onto his left foot and then side foots it past Rubin into the net. 2-1 United, and it's been deserved.
Rashford has been Manchester United's shining light. And he is showing them the way through to maybe the last four in this competition. The finals in Stockholm on the 24th of May. But of course, it offers a route into the Champions League, and that's why everybody inside Old Trafford is celebrating as much. They would have only had themselves to blame had they not dispatched Anderlecht. It means we cannot now have a penalty shootout. However, it also means that they've now got to guard against a second Anderlecht away goal, who are going to have to throw caution to the wind here. As Stanciu out to Akiapong, left hand side, move breaks down, Pogba will clear. Rashford though loses the ball. Bruno then was fouled, free kick to Anderlecht. 12 minutes remain.
Marcus Rashford has been magnificent tonight, absolutely magnificent. He was on Sunday, the weekend against Chelsea. He is a real superstar. His pace, his power, the composure he showed there, and to put away that goal, men round him, great finish.
I think the fourth official may have told Jose Mourinho just to move away from the technical area. Ball has been launched into the box by Tielemans, headed away by Fellaini. Rui Faria at the... No, yeah, it is Rui Faria. I know, in fact, Mourinho will now exchange places. He must have just been testing the patience of the fourth official who told him to go away. But he's decided it is safe back to venture into the technical area once more as Manchester United have finally got a second goal. They lead 2-1, 3-2 on aggregate. They've made heavy weather of it, though, Robbie.
They have missed chances. But the class there from Rashford, he missed one opportunity, but he's kept going, and on that finish, the composure to do the little turn inside the box to get on his left foot, his unfavoured left foot, as Martial goes down the left side.
And Martial continues that run, strong run with pace, coming in now for the left touchline. Can't thread it through, still goes, Mkhitaryan in towards Pogba, Pogba to Thiel, hit the goalkeeper there with a save.
He's got to smash that. Why is he side-footing it? He's made a great run, Pogba. He's on the right hand side, smash it across the goal, he side footed it, and Ruben makes another save.
Well, I remember against Midtjylland last February in this competition when Marcus Rashford was thrust into the limelight with Martial picking up a hamstring injury, and he delivered two goals that night, which was part of a wonderful breakthrough season. What was it? 9 goals in 18 games. This season he's taken his tally into double figures. 3 in his last 4. But it's the goal in extra time. It's the breakthrough goal for Manchester United as they look to join Celta Vigo, maybe Schalke, and then one off Besiktas against Lyon in the semi-final draw. And you'll hear news of that on Radio 5 tomorrow as the ball is clipped long towards Rashford. He just hasn't stopped. He's been tireless.
Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. World class tonight, Marcus Rashford. The way he's gone past people. And he's in again. Oh, no, he's not.
I think he was... Has he lost his shin pads?
Yeah, his shin pads have come. But, you know, his performance tonight... world class, Ian. World class performance. And he has got the potential to be world class. There's no doubt about it. No, the future for England with Dele Alli, with Marcus Rashford, they can produce on the international stage. Wow, Marcus Rashford, absolutely sensational.
He's been terrific, and that's why the FA and Eddie Boothroyd want to take him to the Under-21 European Championships in the summer. He was played the party line, really, when we asked him about that last time when we were with the England setup. He'll do whatever the coaches tell him to do. Manchester United will not want him to suffer from any burnout, but the FA want him to be part of that England setup come the summer in Poland.
But he's got that goal from centre forward position once again, hasn't he? Could it be the winner? Could it be the goal that takes United through? But he was in a centre forward position.
They lead 2-1, and we have 8 minutes remaining in this second period of extra time. As Pogba drifts out towards that right-hand side. Mkhitaryan back with Pogba in towards Fellaini now in the penalty area. The angle is tight. Fellaini still going. And Bodgy goes with him. And it goes out of play. Well, the referee's looking at his assistant to make the decision. The assistant doesn't want to make the decision. And after a brief delay, they decide it is a corner kick.
Yeah, well, Fellaini's done well when he's come on tonight, Ian, as well. He's been a threat. He's won the header for Marcus Rashford's goal. Very good tonight from Fellaini.
So it's going to be a corner kick to Manchester United, who lead 2-1, and it comes aimed towards Fellaini. Caught in the air, though, by the goalkeeper. Remember, this game's still not finished, because Anderlecht now have got to give it a go in these closing stages. 7.5 minutes. And that's what Manchester United now must have to guard against. Tielemans, who's become more and more withdrawn as the game has wore on. Certainly they've missed the influence of Annie, who brought them level earlier in the night. Bruno back to Tielemans, plays it forward. And Bodgy has now gone forward, so they're playing now with one of the central defenders alongside Thelin. Martial loses the ball. Was he fouled? The referee from Spain, Mayenko, says yes he was. And that's supported by the Manchester United supporters.
Yeah, it's good play from Martial. He had the manager before the game talking about Martial, but there he worked hard, he won the ball back for his side, won a free kick deep in United's half. Good play from the winger Martial, working back for the side.
Schalke 3, Ajax 1 is a latest scoreline, which means that Ajax are going through at the moment. Celta Vigo already through, but of course that would be the away goal for Ajax that would see them through against the German side. They're in extra time, as they are in Istanbul. Besiktas 2, Lyon 1, still 3-3 on aggregate. Manchester United still have to be wary of an Anderlecht. A second away goal as Blint will clear the ball long. By the way, the semi-finals would be on the 4th and the 11th, which would be before their games against the two North London teams in the Premier League, Arsenal and Tottenham, in what is going to be a very congested run into the end of the season for Manchester United, with potentially 10 more games still in the offing. Carrick missed that ball as it came towards him in the centre circle, up towards Mkhitaryan. Manchester United now with Mkhitaryan, looks up, out towards Martial. Martial eventually controls the ball left-hand side. He waits and runs back and has Shaw. And we have 5 minutes remaining of this second period of extra time. Plenty more live football to look forward to over the weekend. The Scottish Cup semi-final, Hibs and Aberdeen on Saturday, followed by Swansea against Stoke, Chelsea against Tottenham, and on Sunday we'll bring you news of the London Marathon. We also have the second semi-finals, both in Scotland and in England. The Old Firm, Celtic against Rangers, Arsenal against Manchester City, finishing off with Liverpool against Crystal Palace. And on Monday, to the Championship. Newcastle at home to Preston North End. So lots of live football to look forward to on 5 Live. Manchester United 2, Anderlecht 1. Time running out for Anderlecht. They go long. Mbodji heads it on the edge of the penalty area. Header away by Valencia, tucked in. Mbodji heads it back. And the flag had stayed down. Akir Pong just threw himself at that. He's only about 5'6". And Romero made a save.
Oh, what a chance. He was onside as well. Akir Pong. It was Mbodji who won the second ball. He heads it into the centre of the goal. And Akir Pong, he beats the offside trap. Pogba plays him on. He gets his head to it. Oh, he's got to score there. What an opportunity. Romero with a save.
Wasn't a clean save, but he kept it out nevertheless. 3.5 minutes remain. Anderlecht now coming forward. Bruno looking towards Mbodji. Beaten to the ball, though, by Blint. And Blint's long ball will be gathered in by the goalkeeper, Ruben, away to our left-hand side. So, Tielemans will come forward now. And although a second goal for Anderlecht would be an equaliser, in effect it would be a winner. As the cross comes in, Romero will punch. And we'll get enough on it. Manchester United with Pogba. No time for the fancy stuff when you're 25 yards out for your own goal. He's given it away. Tucked in this time was Valencia. Manchester United at the moment. It's Spajic who has a shot blocked. It's bouncing around in that penalty area. Manchester United at the moment can't get the ball away. Volleyed back in. It's a high ball. It's dropping towards the far post. Romero doesn't know where it is and the referee blows his whistle.
Oh, what's happening? People are lying down the penalty area. The ball's getting hoisted in. United last ditch defending. Throwing everything forward now, Anderlecht. How long's left? 2 minutes.
There's a lot of Manchester United supporters who are heading for the exits. You're about 3 minutes away from the end of the game, and your side are only leading by the one margin, as we've got a stoppage in play because it's Valencia who's just been tying his shoelaces away to our right hand side. Anyway, Romero's going to take it as Manchester United are going to squeeze through to the last four. Unless there is to be a dramatic late twist as Spajic heads it forward and then they come searching towards Akir Pong. It's lifted but gathered in by the goalkeeper Romero. It was almost like rugby union there where the fullback kicks it and everybody goes in search of the ball. Such was the way that those purple shirts haired forward. Romero's quite happy to bide his time. Right footed, clears long. By my watch, we're inside the last 2 minutes of the second period of extra time. 2-1 to United. Martial cuts in off the left touchline. Edge of the area. Mkhitaryan back towards Martial. Flag's raised. It will not count. It's another disallowed goal for Manchester United. And their lead remains at 2-1 on the night.
Correct call. Great play though from Martial with Mkhitaryan. Link up play. 1-2. Just went offside. Is Anderlecht go forward?
So Anderlecht come forward. It's going to be telling as to how much added on time there will be. There shouldn't be too much because there's not been only a brief stoppage, there's been no substitution, so you'd be hardly looking at more than 2 minutes, I would suspect. Valencia controls the ball, almost lets in Akir Pong, gets a challenge in there, the cross into the penalty area, and Budgie heads it over. That was another late scare, and it's a goal kick, as Anderlecht were looking for a corner.
I tell you what, Luke Shaw did ever so well on that back post. The ball's flighted in from Dendonka to the back post. Mbodji stayed up and Luke Shaw just gets his body in the way. Mbodji won it. And Romero, I think, had it covered. Did he touch it? No, I'm not sure he did.
It was another late scare. A warning just to keep the concentration level so high for Manchester United. Manchester United 2, Anderlecht 1. That dual assault on a place for a Champions League place looks like it will still be available for Manchester United as Rashford, who's run himself ragged into the ground, continues to chase a lost cause. Anderlecht will go along. The ball is pumped up towards Mbodji, headed away by Shaw. Martial will try and hold up to the ball, challenged by Appiah, gets himself away. Mourinho actually slips, as now he can celebrate down on the touchline, as Manchester United have seen off the spirited challenge of Anderlecht. They've won 2-1 on the night, 3-2 on aggregate, but a hard-fought victory for Manchester United as they edge their way into the last four of the Europa League, and Jose Mourinho makes his way to this near side to acknowledge the support of Anderlecht, not the supporters of Manchester United. Jose Mourinho is standing in front of the travelling contingent, nodding his head and applauding to the Belgian fans. Some of them have reacted angrily. However, I think that it is a clear sign of the unwavering support, and maybe, who knows, a sly dig at the Manchester United fans who were not as vocal, certainly not as vocal at the weekend. Robbie Savage.
Brilliant game. Marcus Rashford is a superstar, no question about that. The way he took that goal, they created chance after chance after chance. Eventually they put one away, won the game, deservedly so. What a game. Great performance. United into the semi-finals.
Manchester United 2, Anderlecht 1. Manchester United go through 3-2 on aggregate.